I'ma be that more you gon' remember. I be that more you gon' remember. To Harker Bay front line till the law call my number. I be that more you gon' remember. I'ma be that more you gon' remember. That's right. I be that more you gon' remember. To Harker Bay front line till the law call my number.
If you a friend of the Moors, then you a friend of mine. I was told to watch my enemies, now hold my line. Those who speak against the prophet, they speak against me. And I speak about the prophet over Drew Ali. Who was the first to remind you and bind you back to Morocco, the mountains, Mississippi, and Quebec? Told you you wasn't black, proving a straight fact. You tripping off trunks, you need to be tripping off that. Now here we go again, acting like you a slave. The same people took European on the babe. And looking at women, buying European hair. No love for self, but do the men really care? Hell no, cause they got a love for Europe. Whole generation chasing pills, weed, and syrup. Yeah, they love Lil Yachty, Tucci, Gucci, Kodak, Amigos, Ross, Lucy. But when the love for the woman look like your mother, I guess they say it's all black when it's under the cover. Now, I be that more you gon' remember. I'ma be that more you gon' remember. That's right. I be that more you gon' remember. To Harker Bay front line till the law call my number. I be that more you gon' remember. I'ma be that more you gon' remember. That's right. I be that more you gon' remember. To Harker Bay front line till the law call my number.
All you super scholars holler. This era for the workers. You ain't building on the ground, then you worse than a twerker. You look and sound good, but that's only on the surface. Probably working for them people. Now tell me what your purpose. Ain't worried about your homie, but know that I know. Every mo that rock a fast, he ain't my bro. Yeah, you know I ain't slow. I seen it all before. How they try to kill the prophet, it was all for dough. And some got it right now. Don't say that I'm not down. I'm coming for my bastard state. I want my town, my sheriff, my stores, my school, my nation. Sick and tired of the procrastination and debate. Y'all keep hating when love is the savior. You don't love yourself, so you can't love your neighbor. That's why you killing, fighting, Murray out of your race. If you ain't for Moore's world, then get out of my face. Cause Chinese love China, Italians love Italy. If the Haitians love the Moore's world, come on and build it with me. Let's go. I be that more you gon' remember. I'ma be that more you gon' remember. That's right. I be that more you gon' remember. To Harker Bay front line till the law call my number.
Check, check, check. What's good, everybody? Welcome, welcome, welcome back to another edition of No Boys TV. We're going to have Julio jumping up in here in a few seconds. I asked y'all for videos of your dogs, but we're going to do this every Monday. We're going to try to do it every Monday, but that's the plan, to do this every Monday, to get videos of the communities, of not just anybody's dogs. I'm talking about you're gonna have to submit it. We're not just gonna pick anybody's videos and pictures and start showing them and breaking dogs down and their flaws and, you know, where they're correct and where their strong points at and all of that stuff. We're not gonna do that just to any dog, man. We don't get down like that. So you're gonna have to request, you're gonna have to inbox me or Julio a video of your dog moving, and two shots of your dog with a front shot. What's going on, Ace? With the front shot, what's going on? Yes, yes, yeah. My skin look all smooth and everything, right? Bro, I feel good, man. I feel a little bit energetic. I'm still dealing with a few things. You know, I'm on what you would call a protocol, a parasite protocol. So what I'm doing now is trying to detoxify myself with the parasites right now. So you know, it's a process. It's a lifestyle, what I'm doing. So yes, every Monday we're gonna be breaking these dogs down, me, Julio, and whoever sends their request for us to break their dogs down. We're gonna have you on too. We're also gonna have you on live. So we're just waiting for Julio to get in, and you know what I'm about to do, right? Yeah. Yes, sir.
In these times, we gotta hustle, cause our pockets be hurt. Little niggas wanna get funded from who got work. Is you ready for that? You want them wives to bust? Let a nigga know where they at, so ain't no stopping us. If you handle your business right, I'ma promote your ass. You bitch, I didn't try to kite, I'ma come smoke your ass. The shit that I'm giving you, they drawing blood to get. The bigs be running too because they love the shit. So don't come with that. The door wouldn't buy, the shit was cool. Nigga tried to ride me, nobody was coming through. Snitches, I can't have that. Bitches, I can't have that. Riches, you can have that. Just bring me my cash back. Look, it's all red with me, go ahead and shine. That's how you play with me, you big time. All I want is the G's with a trunk, with a key, a Benz on 20s. You got something you can win this shit. Nigga ain't doing nothing for me for free. Can't put my trust in you niggas, cause y'all be trying to run G. Cause I don't like to dream about making no cheese. Wanna see my motherfucking bank account OD. But until then, I'ma be ducking behind a project building. Smoking that fire, keep with the ghetto children. Gliding on the way that we can make a million, million, Lord, Lord, children. I'ma be ducking behind a project building. Smoking that fire, keep with the ghetto children. Gliding on the way that we can make a million, million, Lord, Lord. Now I'm on some shit again. Leave a nigga stranded like Gilligan. 100 G's I'm considering. Next hit for 1 million. Catch a nigga, I'm killing them. They smart, but I ain't feeling them. My jacket on the mirror them. Super serious, numerary. Pines is vociferant. Juvenile is different. Look at what I did to them. Niggas wearing Reeboks instead of Nikes and Timberlands. Bitch niggas, I be tipping them. My Mac 9, they be flipping them. Some of these niggas be trying to run G, so I be chipping them. They would do the same to me. Niggas ain't no family. Shit is all a gain to me, but nobody gon' handle me. 400 degrees. Holding guns, running for keys. No wonder we need more money one could receive. Nigga wanna kill him for stripes. I'ma put it up in his life. Never should have fucked me right. Why you keep ducking me, shite? I'ma knock your head off. Nigga trying to get to you. Fuck trying to play it off. You made the beat, nigga. So why are you scared? If you mind your fucking business, then your life will be spared. I can't see it. Nigga try to make me out of bitch. I can't be it. I had his motherfucker crowding with niggas like Friedman. You probably could save yourself, just can't save y'all here. I'ma knock it to spin all around like a baseball player. Put all this potato on the end of my nine. Coolest since I hit the tan and keep these niggas in line. Look, cause I don't like to dream about making no cheese. I wanna see my motherfucking bank account OD. Up until then, I'ma be thugging behind a project building. Smoking that body weed with the ghetto children. Lying on the way that we can make a million, million love. Up until then, I'ma be thugging behind a project building. Gliding on the way that we can make a million. Smoking it by the people, the ghetto children. Children, children, children. Ask them niggas about me. Let them bitches know me. Magnolia head bust out that wild DC. I'm a young nigga. Look at what you done, nigga. You done made me mad. Now I'm going get my gun, nigga. Better watch your tongue, nigga. Cause I'm getting dumb, nigga. Kill one nigga. Represent where I'm from, nigga. Three things you don't ever do. Fuck with a man, his chain always mama. You do that, you won't drama. Fuck with a big timer, for sure you gon' see. I'm out here, which one of you boys on me? I'ma keep it real with you. You say you're a man, I know I'm a man, and I'm ready to deal with you. I'm prepared for the gold tagging. Keep my Reebok strapped tight with my Depot sagging. Nah, I done rocked a couple of keys and I done flipped that 2 times. I know I'm in the crowd and they gonna pursue mine. I got bills to pay, I can't be playing with you jokers. These youngsters something else now, you bout to just provoke you. You can't understand how a nigga my age can hit the street psyched up, bustin' with the 12 gauge. But I don't like to dream about making no cheese. In the future, wanna see my fucking pockets OD. Up until then, I'ma be duckin' behind a project building. Smokin' that fire, you be with the ghetto children.
What's good? What's good, man? Y'all know how I do, man. I have to play some. Julio, I don't know if I'm about to do this screen record so you can see how you get in here. Hold on, I got you. Let me see. Screen recorder. All right. I'm gonna show you how you get it there. Boom. Boom. Open in Chrome. And that's it. All right. So I'm gonna stop it. All right, Julio, I'm gonna send this to you. I did a screen recording on how I just got in here. You don't need to download anything, fam. You don't need to download anything. Hold on, let me see if it did it. Sorry, y'all. I apologize. It did it. So, I definitely missed y'all, man. I was gonna come on last week, but I was in the middle of that fast, and I didn't have the energy, man. It's I don't think y'all understand what I have to go through to set this up. It's a lot of energy, and it's a lot of brain waves. That's, you know, and it's a lot of, you know, little movements that I had to make that I'd have been dead, not actually died, but I'd have been all out of energy by the middle of the show. So I didn't want to jip y'all of that, you know, of good time. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to give y'all 100% of myself on this show. So, Demon Life Bully says, how many dogs can you send? You can send as many dogs as you want, but we're going to be focusing on a person's dog at a time. So, you know, if you have two dogs, then that next Monday, I'll probably get to it, or whenever I can get to it. If, you know, if we're overwhelmed, then we're going to have to do some kind of system where it's like a pick 'em, you know, where nobody gets overlooked. There we go. All right. What's up, fam?
Yo.
This is my guy, Julio. I didn't want to jack up your last name. I always do. So for the people who've been living under a rock, can you please give everybody your information and let them know who you are, your qualifications, what you've done in this game, and all of that, sir, so we can establish yourself as the legit Don Dada.
Nah, we ain't about to do all that, bro.
Listen, you said it earlier. Hold up. I'm gonna give you your flowers in front of everybody, right? Because you, and that's a dope ass cup. Everybody, that's a dope ass cup. Let me see that cup. Everybody, tap in sevens, man, if y'all like that cup. Man, that cup is dope.
Yeah, man, if anybody knows me, man, I'm a big fan of this, bro.
Yeah, that's what we finna go Super Saiyan, too. We finna go Super Saiyan. So, I wanted to give you your
first one, though, bro. We gotta give it some easy, bro.
Yeah. But yeah, I'm gonna let you know. I'm gonna let you know before we high, man. Before we get there, I'm gonna let you know. Trust me. Just Michael said Dragon Ball Z for life.
Facts, bro.
Facts. That's what's up. You know what I'm saying? Fuck the seven. He just put there right, Chris. Sevens all day. So,
how do you see the comments, bro? Let me see.
Well, I can see it because I'm in this chat. It's part of my program. Yeah, you're gonna have to go in your phone and you can see the comments, but it'd probably be better. What's going on, Travis White? What's popping? How you doing? Everybody, if you don't mind, please post where you from and what your kennel name is. Does it seem like I have a little bit more energy?
Does it, bro?
You know what I'm saying?
You glowing, bro. For real.
Some people. Yes, we will break down pet dogs. If you have a pet dog, yes. Just you know what I'm saying? We will do that just for educational purposes.
I got kicked out of a house for breaking a pet out.
There we go. Upstate New York. M&J's Bullies. Shout out to y'all. Y'all, please. I'm talking really loud, man. I do feel like I got some energy. Maybe it's just my guest that I got on, man. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to give you your flowers right now. You're saying you're not the Don, man, but ever since I've known you, you've been on that all I do is win type tour. You know what I'm saying? Because like you said it earlier, you how many people can say they won nationals 3 years in a row?
Well, I did 1 year, and then my wife won two.
All right. Hey, y'all won nationals. You know what I'm saying? Y'all won nationals. 3 years, Duval Bullies Nick, well, out of Rhode Island.
Now let's clarify, bro. It was for, I did it for the oldie,
mm-hmm.
and she did it with the English. For the English Bulldog.
Okay. All right. I can see where you're coming from.
Yeah,
because,
yeah.
I got you.
Being honest, you feel me? It's a different level of attendance at that, even though we get a lot.
You won nationals. Listen, you won nationals.
Thank you, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Were you top dog that year?
Yeah, but with a different dog.
Oh wow. That is impressive.
With a different dog.
Man. So you produced both dogs?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right. How'd it go down?
Nothing. Acquired a dog from the big homie.
Mm-hmm.
And told him I was going to push the dog to where I pushed him at. And if I say it, I try to do it. You feel me?
That's what's up. Holly Reese, Virginia Southern, love of the Bullies.
Frankie.
Hey, Cindy and Ken Jones was popping. North Carolina.
Yo,
Amen. Bullies.
Peoples,
exactly. Travis White. He says he's originally from Memphis, Tennessee, but he's in Austin, Texas now. And Bigger Picture Bullies LLC. Shout out to Bigger Picture Bullies LLC. Christopher Hines, Detroit Motor City Bullies. Nick Duval Bullies. We all know the infamous, the most, the hostess that does the mostest. Duval Bullies. You know what I'm saying? Y'all are the host of the Bully Game. So, you know, shout out to Duval Bullies, everybody that's in that camp, man. They're doing it big with the Frenchies, the American Bullies. Now,
they're doing their thing, man. Yo, I seen them. What did I see them at? I seen them at in North Carolina, dude. Mm. I had to take the time out and really, really, really commend them for what they're doing. Yo, for real. That was the first time that I seen them in a while, and I had to take the time out and commend Pre for.
If it wasn't for them. If it wasn't for their forward thinking,
mm-hmm.
you know, when I came into the game, and you know what, they pounded in me. They didn't say, oh, he's new. You know what I'm saying? It was more family. So it was more love, you know, poured into
Everybody
it.
Everybody wins.
Right. Versus, oh, this is just a new dude. And you know, and
let me take
in
advantage
the group.
Of him like everybody else does.
Yeah, or just, you know, it's not as personal, you know. So if one of your brothers or cousins or, you know, family members came into the Bully Game, you're going to treat them like, yeah, it's going to be like, oh, yeah, you want to do this? I bet.
Yo, so it's going to know what's the worst.
Mm-hmm.
When your family members get dogs from somebody else.
Oh,
yo, it don't even got to be my breed, bro. You didn't even take guidance.
Right, to say
some bread and
right,
whatever somebody sold you.
But what if they knew what they was doing?
I don't have them on social media.
Shout out to Dallas. Shout out to Dallas. We got Broom Bullies,
Yo,
from
Rob,
Colorado.
What's up, homie?
Los Asmontos, Colorado. Hold on, I ain't say that shit right. I said Los Asmontos.
Los what? What are you talking about?
I don't know what the fuck. I just hold on. I'm gonna put it up. You're gonna laugh at me. I'm dumb. Right? Yeah. So, what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be asking the public, you know, if it doesn't matter if it's a pet home dog. What we will not stand for, though, is anybody submitting other people's dogs.
Oh yeah, I didn't even
and telling asking us to break that dog down. That will not be tolerated. It has to be your dog.
Yo, let me ask you a question.
What's going on, fam?
All right. Over your years, and I know it's going to be a couple of them, but what dog has made you, oh shit, in person when you've seen them? Good or bad?
we're gonna keep it positive. You know what's messed up?
What?
The dogs that I can say what made me drop my jaw weren't mm-hmm. show dogs. They were usually dogs that popped up at the show. Okay. People that's just walking up mm-hmm. with an oldie that fucking got a head this goddamn mm-hmm. big and bone, you know, big as a horse. Mm-hmm. And or somebody that pulls up with the XL American Bully that big as a, like, oh, at your show that you had in Virginia Beach. It was a dude that showed up with an XL Bully. I think he attacked somebody. Did it bite somebody? Y'all kicked him out of the show? Nah, I don't think it was your show. Nah, it might have been the Allentown show. Not this past time, but I can't remember. But usually it's dogs that aren't in the show ring because I can say I seen Zero. But when I seen Zero, I was in demon mode. I was in demon time because it was 2019 mm-hmm. and Hove and Jaws were tied for number one after one show. Right. Mm-hmm. So I seen them. They were coming to Allentown mm-hmm. and they were talking about, oh, you going to take two. I'm going to take two. I was like, really? Okay, they didn't know that I had something with a loaded clip.
How many did you take?
I took three shows out of four.
You mad silly, son. You mad silly, man.
I took three best in shows out of four shows. But that's just a competitive nature in me.
Nobody was mad, right?
Yes.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, real. there was some hurt feelings. There was definitely some hurt feelings because one thing that I learned that will
Xavier with Hove?
Xavier wasn't showing.
It was Hove,
number one Hove. But it was what's his name showing him on
that dog. We're talking about the same dog.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
Tristan.
So that's the first time Tristan ever seen shots fired.
You probably had him looking like that, like Pumbaa,
bro.
You probably had him like Pumbaa from Timon and Pumbaa. You probably had him looking.
Bro, we only went to 15 shows that year. We were bouncing from number one to number two.
Yeah, he was impressive, bro.
So
he was impressive.
So, it's one thing I learned, especially from you. You taught me this out of North Carolina. You probably don't even remember this.
I smoked too much, bro.
I came. I don't think you were smoking then. This was like exactly. This.
I remember now, bro.
You done dropped off some.
I was still in the Matrix then, bro. I was still in the Matrix then, bro.
All right, so, I came to. This was in 2019. I came to North Carolina, mm-hmm. ready. Oh, I killed. This show, I killed that show. I killed that show. Yo, we finna kill this show. We about to take none but bodies. We didn't win shit. Bro, I was so fucking mad. I was so upset. What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Eddie, Western Mass bullies.
Oh, is that the homie Eddie?
In the that's building. The homie yes. Eddie? That's the homie Eddie right there.
That's homie. Yo, that's homie. Good people. That's yes, good people, bro. Eddie's good people.
I love the path from what I'm seeing as a visual, from what he's showing. I love the path that he's going in right now. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful to watch. And I'm glad that I can be a part of, you know, watching it. You know, I love you, fam. All right. So, Brian, Mr. Romero.
Oh man, he's here?
Yeah, we were talking about him earlier. That's the guy.
Is that Brian with the I or Brian with the Y?
That's the Brian with the Y.
Nah, I'm messing with him. He knows what I'm talking about. He knows what I'm talking about. I'm messing with him.
So you told me, you pulled me to the side, right? Because I was ready to bust somebody's head off. It was so bad. It was so bad. Tone was like, let me show him in show three. maybe he'll get it. But he didn't, you know, it just wasn't his day. Mm-hmm. For some reason, he broke out in hives and it shit was just crazy, dog. He would,
it'd be like that. Your dog would be great the night before.
Your dog, bro, he was great too. He was great too. Nick was with me. Nick was with us at that show. We drove.
Nick be lying. Nick be lying. So it ain't credible. Nick be lying.
So what happened? What happened is you put me to the side. You said, bro, I know you probably don't want to hear this right now, but you need to chill out because what the energy that you're putting out is not you. Mm. I said, bro, I thought I was going to come. He was like, see, that's what you fucked up. And see, this is why I have so much respect for you, because you're not going to hold punches back. You're going to say it how it is. You know what I'm saying? And you was just like, that's what you fucked up. You thought you was coming here and all them trophies was, you might as well, you thought you could just walk up here and just mark which trophy you wanted.
Oh, it'd be like that, bro.
Bro, you was so right.
Sometimes you got to take those L's, bro, to bring you back to reality.
That's what fucked them up.
You probably slipped on something, or you were doing too much with him, or something. Something wasn't right that didn't allow him to do what he was supposed to do, bro.
Facts.
Yeah, it'd be like that, man.
And I'm not gonna say I never got upset after a show after that, mm-hmm. but that was a very valuable lesson, and I think we overlook in this bully game that we've learned some of the most valuable lessons in our lives within this community. And we shun the community. We're quick to put the middle finger up to the community. And at the end of the day, I do it myself, man. But hindsight's 2020 every day, all day.
Every second, bro. It's 2020, bro. Every second is 2020. But nah, it's like that though. Like I remember when I first started showing, and I remember using the same, I don't want to say excuses, but like the same reasoning as now I'm seeing people use. Oh, it's politics. Oh, it's this. Oh, it's that. Oh, it's this. They just can't understand whatever the reason was. I'm not I don't know what ring that we were in, right? Whatever. Sometimes you just gotta take it, bro. Sometimes you gotta take it. You feel me? And then just learn from it and rock out. Sometimes it's called paying your dues, bro.
Man, I can tell you one thing. Taking it is something different. You know, it's definitely something different. It's not something you just take lightly. You know what I'm saying? I think a lot of people forget about the steps within the journey versus the end game or how it started. You know what I'm saying? It's what's important is in between, and those simple steps within the journey. The, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, bro.
Exactly. Yeah, the process. That's the simplest way to say it, is the process during that, you know, during that hike. You know, remembering certain things, admiring certain things, learning, you know. But anyway, I'm sorry, everybody. Julio, please drop your qualifications, your experience. I ain't got nothing, man.
I don't got no education. On
man, you better stop that.
Listen, man, I'm just somebody who is in love with the community, is in love with breeding and creating, and in love with teaching. You understand? Like I love to have a conversation with everybody, but also not everybody's ready to have the conversation. So you got to be careful. Yeah, bro, that's all I am, man. Besides that, I guess I'm ABKC judge. All I do is ABKC. I don't do any other registry. I don't show any other registry. I never have. All my dogs are ABKC only registered. that's the brand that I push, and that's the brand I stand by. You feel me? So whether right or wrong and whatever they do, I got to rock with them. You feel me? Because that's the choice I made. You understand?
That's, like, that's respect, man. I would definitely respect that. I love the ABKC, man. Even, you know, it's always going to be some kind of riff raff or things you don't like within.
Yeah, things you disagree with. Yeah, bro. But it is what it is. You know what I mean? But yeah, bro. Besides all that, everything else is just showing dogs. I've shown a little. I've won a little. We got a couple of top dogs here. A couple years, like maybe 2-3 years. I'm not 100% sure. It's been a while.
Can you see that right there?
Huh?
You can see that right there.
I can see what I can confirm this.
Yeah, I flashed it. That's from the chat. I'm just letting you know. You know, I'm popping up things, and I'm letting you know where it's at, just in case. You can keep on speaking, but you know. I'm just letting you know where it's at.
All right. Yeah, I can see it, bro. Yeah, Frankie, I've had a good conversation with him. But I don't know, bro. Besides that, that's it, man. Ain't nothing fancy over here. It's just good old me, bro. A good old guy y'all can talk to some you can have a good conversation about dogs with. That's it.
Right. Facts. That's all I am. All right. So let me see if I can share this screen. Yes, I can. Boom. Can you see that?
Oh, shoot. People actually send videos?
Damn. Yeah, somebody sent me a video. It's not that long. Here we go.
That's the dog I'm breaking down?
Yes.
All right.
I wish they would zoom in.
Yeah.
Come on, buddy. Oh, there you go. All right, good. That's a good shot. As soon as the judge does his job. It's not like we can say get the fuck out of the way.
What class is this?
I'm not sure. It looks like classic. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm. All right. That's one.
I should be taking notes. Give me 1 second. Let me give me a pencil.
There we go. Here we go. This is what they asked for. This is what they get. All right. Let me get
whose the dog other is one. That? Whose dog was that first video that you or what was the name of the dog?
Select Daniels.
Select Daniels?
Yeah, AVI.
AVI.
Select Daniels.
Then, whatever.
And he said he can take all the critique, all of that stuff. He can take all of that. All right, so that I went back to the same one. Let me go to the other one he gave me. There we go. All right, boom. This is a better shot. It's
same only dog? Two.
Yeah, it's only 2 seconds.
How old's the dog? Did they tell you that?
Nah, they didn't give me all of that information.
No, that's fine.
So this is something for the future for me to, when we're doing this, I can actually say, okay, what's the age, all of this. I was just so excited to do this shit that I just threw all caution to the wind.
Bro, you got me mad excited too, bro. I yo, bro, man.
So we're gonna do this every Monday?
I mean, bro, whatever you want.
If you,
I'm here for you.
Hey, hit the sevens if you want us to do this every Monday. Hit the sevens. All right, so here we go. Let me blow it up real quick. Let me stop it. I knew why the dog. Let me see. Let me add. Here we go.
You said it sent you a better video?
It's a damn, what the fuck? I can't get it now. I don't know what the fuck's going on. All right, hold up. Let me take these two out. Go back there. All right. Let me see. All right. That's why I messed up.
You always messing up, man. Come on. Get your shit together.
All right, boom. Share. All right. See this, right?
Okay.
So
that ain't the same. Oh, yeah, it is the same dog.
It is the same dog.
Different angle.
Different angle. A better angle for us to make.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah, that was it. We've seen it moving.
I mean, it's not the best videos. It's not the best this, but I can say that it's a very, very snipey dog. It appears to be very loaded in the shoulders, very forward in the shoulders, I guess you can say. And I think
can you break down what forward in the shoulders, overloaded in the shoulders for the people that
have 35 to 45 degree angle in the shoulders, leaning back like this. The dog is a little forward. You understand what I'm saying? That's why the movement, it can't reach the way it's supposed to reach. It can't do certain things.
So what he means by the reach, he means that when the dog's front leg is fully extended, it needs to level with his nose or his muzzle. When that's the reach that it needs to achieve for the front. Maybe you can explain a little bit more about the reach that needs for the rear, but go ahead. It's overloaded in the front.
It's a little bit slightly. It ain't horrible. It's a 2 second video on the one, and you know what I mean? And the other one, the judge was in front of it the entire time. It looked to be a little roachy. It looks to lack angulation in the back, especially right there in a still shot that you got it in.
Mm-hmm.
But all that comes from everything affects everything. That's the best way to put it. You know what I mean? The shoulders will affect the lack of. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Like everything. That's why.
It's a domino effect.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. Bug.
I hate living out. That's the only thing I hate about living out in the fucking woods, man.
Oh, I forgot. You.
Goddamn.
You got land out in the middle of nowhere. I forgot.
Yo, these.
Damn, bro, I'm envious of you, bro. I can't right now. The girls are up. Sheesh.
What happened?
The girls are up. I'm envious of you right now.
Man, I would have my daughter right here. I ain't that bad. I would have put it in the corner over there somewhere playing with some toys.
I ain't ready to have that combo yet, bro. I ain't ready.
I feel you. Yeah. I feel you. It's kind of uncomfortable.
Soon. I will not lie. You understand what I'm saying? But
so how long have you been a judge? First.
I don't know.
What dogs have you start? What dogs did you start with? When you first, I know you was probably Obies. A kid. When you was a child?
When I was a baby?
Yeah.
Pits.
Pit bulls?
Pit bulls.
And that was an East Coast thing, like a mother.
Like pit bulls.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like pit bulls. And then I got a little bit of the Staffordshire / pit bully look, the bigger. I got into that for a while. Yo, dude, I used to bring them home and I used to threaten my parents, like, nah, if you kick the dog out, I'm leaving too. I'm running away to keep the dog. Yeah, bro. I've had dogs forever, man. Forever.
And how many dogs? What's the most dogs that you had at your parents' house at once?
I'd say two dogs and a litter.
All right, that ain't that bad.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? That's not that bad.
I wouldn't OD.
All right. So, what valuable lessons, would you have for people that's just getting into the American bully game, that before they even get there, for this is for the dude that's watching, that's doing his research on American bullies. What would you say to that person before he buys his first dog?
Sheesh, bro.
I know you wish your daughters were asleep right now.
Oh, 100%, bro. I have my brand new box. Did you see the box that I posted and my gift? My smoke box?
Bro, no, I didn't see. Hold on. Let me look.
Yeah, it's on my story, bro. Like, I'd have that right in front of me, man. But the one thing that I would tell people, like, if they want to, I would say attend shows and find a dog that you like. Go look at the dog that you like and then follow that person who owns that dog and see if the rest of the dogs that he has look like the dog that you like. You understand? To me, it seems like so much common sense.
It's
but,
not.
But I don't see people making the most, the best decision sometimes. You know what I mean?
Bro, I've had to, I know you've probably had, cause you've had, you know, top oldies. And I know you probably had to tell people like, what do you want to do with your program? Because they're enamored with your male. They just want your male semen. They think that they can produce another one of him. And they gonna, you know, they got it in their head that that's what's going to happen.
I've asked people like, that inquire about a dog and I don't stud a lot. I mean, not that anybody has had dramatic interest in my stuff or anything like that, but I've also, first question that I ask is, what are you breeding to? They tell me what they're breeding to. And the second question is, okay, what do you think, what do you want from my male? Mm. Like, what are you expecting from him? Some people will be like, size. Like, for example, CT. Some people will be like, oh, I want size. Yeah, he's not going to give you that, bro.
Right.
Like, don't even bother using him. I don't want you being disappointed, bro. He's not going to give you that.
That was a dope boy right there.
Yeah, he was tight. He was tight.
He was tight. Love that boy.
I have a son over here, bro. He's twice a dog, bro. Yeah, bro.
So you go bust about. That's going to be crazy.
Nah, he's not a show dog. He's not all a show dog. He's not a show dog. Now, he gave me a daughter. You understand? A CT granddaughter who, yeah.
She bought that life?
Yeah. In every single aspect, bro.
So when you busting her out?
I made a mistake with her.
Oh, Lord. You sold her.
Nah. I got land, bro. I keep
everything. You got it fixed?
No.
All right.
I can't walk on a leash.
Why not? Oh, she pet from it?
She's a kennel dog, bro. She ain't never had a leash around her neck. Now I can do it.
Don't you could do it.
I just don't feel like it. I don't feel like going through that through that again, bro.
People don't understand that it's not just walking the dog. It's balance involved. It's you have to create your own space between each other. Your dog has to understand this is how far he needs to be, and if he's veering off, he needs to go back this way.
I tell people all the time, like, oh, what can I do for my dog? What can I do? Walk him, but you walk your dog. Don't let the dog pull you. Just you gotta walk your dog. Walk your dog, and it's not in the, you. When somebody hands me a dog, I can tell if the dog is walked or not. Isn't that crazy? Like, as soon as somebody's like, yo, can you show my dog? I'll be like, yeah, let me see it. I'm like, yeah, this dog has never been walked on the leash before. Like, never. Like, everybody, that's, if you're showing, walk your dog. Walk your dog.
And make it fun too.
Yeah, you always gotta make it fun. What's up, baby?
Yo. You
in the camera? No?
So, she'd have been like, daddy, what is he doing?
Yeah, they have no idea what's going on. This is the first time I'm ever, every time I sit down.
Hey, here, man, I appreciate it.
Look at this, bro. This I'm at the work area.
Man, I really appreciate it, man. I do this for, I seriously do it because I love this breed. I love the community.
What's your next step?
What do you mean?
What's your next step?
Man, we could talk about this off camera, bro. But I got some shit that I'm doing, bro. What I can say I'm doing right now, I have so many options, bro. But I'm gonna be smart, and the two females that I have, mm-hmm. I'm gonna breed them to two different dogs. Mm-hmm. One's a shots fired daughter, and I'm gonna just create through them. Basically, I'm not gonna let you know. The blood is gonna be what the blood is. You know what I'm saying? I'll let you know. But I definitely I'm trying to get into my own production, my own, where I produce the mother and the father, where I produce the sisters and the brothers. You know, I want to be at that point. And you can't rush it. It's just something that you have to come to grips with and say, this is going to be a slow grind.
It's never ending, bro.
Never ending.
That's a fact. It's never ending. There's always something.
Thank you, Frankie.
There's always something, bro. Like, there's always something. You want to fix something, boom, you got it, and then there's something else. It's never ending. Damn, I want to do this. Damn, I want to do this. And then you forget about the three things ago, and you're like, oh, shoot, I'm starting to lose it. Oh, shoot. Nah, let me go back. I got something for this. I bred something for this. I kept something in the tuck just for this.
So
you know what you're doing.
If you know what you're doing, just like you said, mm-hmm. you know it takes time. You know it takes time because you want to see what that male's producing. You want to see what that comes off of that dog. And I had time to sit back to see that what that blood does. You know what I'm saying? So I can bring it. And not too many people are using it. A lot of people know it, but not too many people are using that blood as of right now. There's, you know. But I'm jumping on it, and I'm gonna capitalize off of it.
Do you mind sharing what that is? What blood?
It's Magoo. It's Magoo. It's more Magoo because I have that hair. Mm-hmm. My shots fired daughter is basically, you know, and Pup Smoke. You know, they're Demon Boy. That's Demon Boy. You know, they got World Star. You know, they come from World Star, a World Star granddaughter, both of them. So I can
infamous World Star, huh?
So I can vent. See, that's what I'm saying. People are asleep. You know what I'm saying? People are sleeping on that blood because it was hype when he was here, right? But people forget about Powerball. People forget about dogs like that. You know what I'm saying? That he produced and other dogs, fire ass dogs.
He was a dope little dog. What World Star was a dope little dog. Powerball wasn't that who? Powerball. What do? Where's that dog? Panama.
See, that's the girth I want. That's the bone that I want in my dogs. I don't want to overdo it, but I want to be on that line where I'm tap dancing like Gregory Hines on it. You know what I'm saying?
Yo.
But then I want to add the structure as well. Not saying that dog's not structurally sound. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying I want to add structure where it's bulletproof.
Bulletproof structure. That's hard, bro.
It is, but it's why not? Why, you know, if I aim high for the sun and I fail and I reach a star, man, I'm good. You know what I'm saying? I can plan from there.
I feel like, just my opinion, but I feel like the breed right now
mm-hmm.
is at a point where what we want for the dog, the type, has to come with some flaws, and we have
it
to
definitely be okay does,
with it. And we have to be okay with it.
But what I mean is, when you stack that dog up,
mm-hmm.
only a trained eye like your person, such as yourself, can say, "Oh, that dog has a flaw, but it's minor." You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's a minor flaw. Yeah, all right. Oh, yeah, he has a couple of flaws, but yeah, they're minor.
Mm-hmm.
That's when we know we're moving in the right direction, when we can actually say things like that. And that's what I'm trying to create. If I miss, it's, you can't say I ain't try. You know what I'm saying?
Mad at you, bum.
So that's what I'm aiming for. But, you know, I'm not aiming for it at the same time. What I'm aiming for right now is the girth and the bone and the headpiece. And, you know, the head shape, muzzle. That's, I'm going for the silhouette right now. I guess you can say not the whole, at least for the headpiece, I'm going for the silhouette.
You're focusing on head type.
Definitely. Definitely. I don't want to over exaggerate it, but I know how far to go. You know, I don't want the nose being turned up. You know what I'm saying? I see some of these dogs where people say it's fire and their nose is turning up and they look like a bulldog.
But that's what they like.
Exactly. It's what they like. It's what they like. But they say American bully. But when you're right. But that's, to me, I'm different because that's a flawed American bully. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? What you say, they might have something to tighten that up. They might have something in their yard where they know if they breed to this blood right here or breed to this type of flaw, that then that they're not gonna come out with it, because that happens.
You know what I've noticed a lot? Weak under jaws.
Why? Not wire jaw. That's like
no. Weak.
Weak. Weak. Right. Let's go. Hold up. I'm gonna pull it up.
What you pulling up?
The American bully.
Frankie said when the toes turn up. I think he's being freaky, yo.
Freaky Zeke. Don't get the nickname Freaky Zeke in your hair now.
Oh, man. You got to play some music.
Oh, shit. All right.
Who's dope? He's a dope Aaron to some of Nico stuff, I believe. What are you talking about?
All right. Now, what were we talking about? We were talking about,
how do you like trades in? You lion breed. Just remember, you get the good and you get the bad.
You definitely do.
So remember that.
Oh, man.
That's funny, bro. People lion breed just to say 100 times this.
They do. They don't understand the science. It's a science behind it.
Bro.
It's an actual science behind. While y'all doing all that, moving forward with the breed, please work on the breathing. For sure.
Who said that?
Yella? Yeah, Yella one.
Looks like you got some working dogs. You see, you got some working dogs.
Isn't it? It's funny
talking that crap.
Yeah, I know, right? It's funny. It's funny how you, Yella, you're actually standing on so many generations of people who's bred work. You're standing on their shoulders, right? While we're actually working. So,
oh, man, it's hard.
We're actually hard. Working. And what I'm respectfully, you know, you can come on here and we can debate. Mm-hmm. You know, we can respectfully do it. But you're standing on generations and generations. I'm talking about a long line of generations of people who dealt with issues that you don't even know about with the American Pit Bull Terrier or whatever breed that you dealt with when they first came into conception within their first 20 years. Trust me, they dealt with shit.
I could imagine.
And there's people, and it's easy to point your finger right now at a dog that we're trying to. He said, I dealt with the American bullies for 15 years. Done with them now. Cool. Run out. We see the smoke and a fire when you bust out the door, too. It's cool.
You stupid.
It's cool, man. But it's easy. But it's like we're doing. So you've dealt with the dog for 50. You've dealt with dogs. So you know the work, the time, the effort.
It's hard, bro. It's hard.
You know what goes into this. You know what goes into this, but this shade right here, that shade, yeah, bye, exactly. Goodbye. Goodbye. Exactly.
You took it as shade. Let me see the comment. Wait, let me see the comments. I didn't know that's where we were going. Hold on.
You know what I'm saying? Goodbye.
I don't see those comments, bro. I don't see none of the yellow. None of that.
Look, it's up there right now. I'm putting it up. Right, hold on. There it is, right there. Boom. While y'all doing all the moving forward with the breathe, please work on the breathing.
My dogs breathe. You know,
So what's your advice to a person that has an American bully, right?
Uh-huh.
That that isn't as game, because that's a thin line right there when you start dealing with gamey American bullies versus American bullies.
Okay, I'm listening.
So what did, like, this guy right here, man, he likes those pit bull type American bullies. Mm-hmm. He likes the American bullies what the XLs look like right now.
Who are we talking about? Yella?
Yeah.
All right. So he likes the American bullies.
He likes the old school. Pit bull. No, it's not.
He likes pit bulls. He doesn't like American bullies.
He said he dealt with it for 15 years. Here we go.
He probably dealt with a different. How do I say?
Who blocked you? I didn't block you.
Huh?
You ain't blocked, fam.
I didn't block anybody. I'll show you my block list.
And if you take it as shade, I took that comment as shade.
Oh, here we go.
You know what I'm saying? You saying this is shade. Now you wanna, you know, throw the rock and hide your hand now. That's cool, man. That's cool. But I apologize, man. If it seems a shade to you, I apologize. Let me take the bass out my voice.
So, for example, like he said, he's dealt with bullies for 15 years, right? Mm-hmm, but that means 15 years ago, correct?
There it is right here. He said, I dealt with American bullies for 15 years. I'm done with them now.
He probably dealt with a different version of the American bully. You understand? Listen, the version of 2 years ago isn't yesterday's price is not today's price.
And I can understand what you're saying, right? But the people come on here and throw shade, you know what I'm saying? Yella, I apologize if you didn't mean it as shade. I apologize for going off on you, brother. I am wrong. All right. If you wasn't throwing shade, I apologize. And I can stand on what you're saying is correct.
Hey, yeah, show us a video of your dogs, man.
And what's crazy is the mind frame people have that we want to breed dogs that breathe bad.
Hell no.
That can't run. That can't work.
Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not breeding working dogs.
No, I'm not.
Y'all can get that out your system. Like, I'm not, don't, that's not what I want to breed. Mm-mm. But I do want to breed a functional dog that can go out on summer walks, long walks. You understand what I'm saying? There's a difference. That's what people need to understand. Just because your dog can walk doesn't mean it can work.
Exactly. Like sometimes you don't take a Frenchie to go hunt hogs.
Not sometimes, never. Never.
Bro. That's what I was saying.
Never, bro.
That was the point that I was trying to make.
Go get yourself a band dog and go get busy. Bro.
Facts. That's what I'm saying. You get another dog, man.
Different breed.
Yeah, get a different breed.
That's it.
Let me see what the comment said, man. Some people don't use XL for gaminess, though. I don't know anybody that uses XLs for...
I wouldn't use an XL for no game. I want a small dog.
They move horrible, man. They don't move good. They don't move. XLs don't move good to me. They're sloppy, clumsy. They'll break something, tear something. They'll fuck something up trying to run.
Think about it. AI or Yao Ming? Who's more agile?
Now, don't get me wrong. I know there's some XLs out there that can go do it, right? But are they truly XLs?
I don't know, bro. Let me not even comment on that. Oh no.
You know, if I'm hunting a hog, I want a dogo. You know what I'm saying?
Dogos are dope. I always wanted that. Dogos are dope.
Yeah, they ain't good with other dogs though.
Give me that. Give me.
From what I heard.
I'll be honest with you, bro. That's the way I like mine.
Oh yeah, I'm smoking that.
We're gonna have to stay this after bedtime, bro, because I wanna cough with you.
All right, bet. Fuck it.
I wanna cough with you, son.
So, since we got past that, man, I apologize to this guy. If he didn't mean it like that, I took the shade.
Bro, if he's still on, yo, yella, send a video in, bro. I'm curious to see what you got.
And what dog?
Curiosity.
Because
I like game bred dogs, bro. For real. I love them.
He said, bro, drink some water. Okay, I got you.
I'm drinking coffee, bro. Black.
I was making his mouth dry. He said, bro, drink some water.
Who said that?
He was trying to swallow for me. He was like,
Kelvin's on here. You still on here, Kelvin?
So you're on a Facebook Messenger. I can see that here too. But I'm on my StreamYard, so I can see both. I can see YouTube and I can see
Facebook. I can see the comments here too. Yeah, here we go.
10:05.
I'm like an extreme bulldog and Julio like a game dog.
Frankie Santos. Yeah, he's
over there comparing body types. Yo, you know who made a really dope post about that? Anthony Gray.
Man, that dude has so much. I can't wait to have him on here too.
My man is very knowledgeable, bro. Very, very knowledgeable. Mention XL. Wait, what?
Should we have a funeral for that motherfucker?
Oh,
a bug, man. Some of these bugs, I don't even know what the hell they are, man.
Where you at, outside?
Nah, I'm in the room.
Well, you got your window open. You wild.
Nah, I ain't got the window open, man. Sometimes they just get in.
That's how you let the chupacabras in, bro.
It just happened like that, bro. They just get in. I spray around the house and everything, man. These motherfuckers on steroids.
Yeah, bro, I can't. You want to know what's on steroids over here, bro? Is the damn grass growing.
Sheesh. Here too, man. Oh, it's been raining too. It's been raining.
My zero turn about to take a crap on me, bro.
Chupacabra. What state you in? Who you talking about, John? Me or Julio?
I'm in PA.
I'm in Virginia. Shit don't make no sense. It don't make no sense. Yeah, I'm in Virginia, man. I'm in Virginia. I moved to Virginia a year ago.
How is it? You love it? Hate it?
Man, when you stay on so much, when you stay on so much property, like when I walk to the back, that's how I used to walk to the fucking store back in the city, man. You know what I'm saying?
Just taking a walk.
And there's facility shit back there. There's shit back there. You know what I'm saying? Pole barn, another house, all kind of shit. Two yards with separate fences, with dog kettles in them. A fucking pole barn with dog kennels set inside of there. But a tree just fell through the shed back there. Six right now.
Are you lightweight with it right now?
I had like. I was going on like 9 or some shit like that.
Dude, we've had 20.
Dog, I was not going to do it. I wasn't going to do it because you know what? I seen it. This ain't going nowhere. I seen my program. The shit wasn't going. This is not the dogs that I want to be represented by. Because these aren't the dogs that I really want to actually do breedings with now. Because the dogs that I really want to do breedings, one is Pup Smoke. She's here. She's too young to do the breeding. I did her second heat. She fucking, it was my fault because I misread the machine. So. Yeah. And Brian hit me up and he let me know how to actually, what numbers to use to read that machine. So I'm readily available now for that to go down. And I'm bringing it with shots fired. So
you're doing Pup Smoke the Shots?
Yeah. So they both come from charisma. So basically the two-time charisma breeding. Her father, Kodak Black, and shots fired. So
Kodak Black, that's a funny name.
Yeah. So I seen it, man. I said I'm not gonna fucking do this shit because I seen breeders. I could have did breeders and sold dogs and all of that shit, or would have been stuck with dogs. I don't know, but I wasn't gonna go down that path, man. And my wife was already
everybody's wife is like that, bro.
And she never done that. Like bro, that. She never done that. She's never done that because you know she see it, she's seen it too. You know what I'm saying? What the fuck are we gonna do with these dogs? She seen it too. She didn't see it. It wasn't nothing calling her. Mm. So I understood what she was saying. We downsized, and it is what it is. You know, some dogs we gave away for free. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is, man.
It's hard. It's hard rehoming dogs too, man. Especially when you've had them for so long.
Yeah,
you see what I'm saying? Like once you've had a dog, now I'm seeing the guy yellow's comments on the side. Now that I got it,
this dude says,
"Oh, you got somebody from Hawaii on here, bro?"
Yes, sir. That's my guy.
Yeah, you know him.
Yeah. Well, he's on here every time I go live, bro.
What's Rob talking about Masters for?
I don't know. What's up, Troy?
Somebody say you smoking those meds, bro.
Alright. Yeah. It's my prerogative. Mm. Nah, but
whatever happened to the dude, Select Daniels. We told him what he told him, and that's it.
I guess so. Yeah, but shot Lance. Lance Lee, I can't wait to have you on here. Definitely reached out to him. I think I'm gonna work out something to have Lance on here because I love the movement that he has going on.
What is he doing?
Lance, I'm gonna send you this link real quick. I don't know if you can come in.
Who you adding, Lance?
Yeah. Hold up.
Do I know him?
Yeah, you know, man.
For real? Don't be lying to me, Joe. Yo, I can't believe you sent me a screen.
I'll show you who he is.
On how to get this going. That was dope. Thank you.
That shit was dope. That shit's easy, right?
No, I had to download Google Chrome. Cause Safari, right. this thing doesn't Safari doesn't support what you got.
So you know BWO, right?
I can't see that, bro. Oh, BWO, yeah, I know that.
Bully World Order,
like the NWO logo. Yeah.
So what he's put together, I remember. When he first started showing and he took off from that, bro, he's been on a tear since then. From productions,
I remember seeing him
to building his empire, what he got right now. I respect
Oklahoma
it.
Show?
Excuse me,
I think I remember seeing him at an Oklahoma show like 2 years ago. The first time,
I'm gonna send him a link right now.
If it's the same person we're talking about.
Yeah, definitely probably the same person you're talking about. I'm gonna send it to your inbox right now. Boom.
Yo, this is dope, bro.
Anybody else want to come on? Just let me know. We can make that happen. You know what I'm saying? I sent the link to your messenger. We can make that happen. If you want to ask Julio some questions, in-depth questions, get something broken down more further. Yo, this is the only platform that does it like this, man.
Yeah, bro, this is dope. I haven't seen anybody do it like this.
Nick wants me to send him. Yep.
Yeah. Man, leave Nick. Go, man. My man, Nick.
He's probably at work. You at work, Nick? Oh, there we go. Mr. Lance Lee, what's popping, fam?
What's up, guys?
Yes, sir. How's everything going with you?
Shit, man, good. I can't complain. Just busy. Summertime's busy time of the year for us, man.
So, well, now, see, I don't even want to get into asking you any questions because I want to set this up for Sunday. But I wanted Julio to just introduce you to Julio, like,
yeah, I know Julio. I've shown under Julio a few times.
We got our feet kicked up right now. We rolling up, you know. We you could spit tobacco in the cup right now. You know what I'm saying? You could, you know, do it. You know, fart. You know, burp. That's what we relaxing right now.
What y'all talking about?
Well, Julio was gracing us with his knowledge about it's not just one thing on the dog. So when we see a dog with weak pasterns, that's not the root of the issue. Or you see a dog moving a certain way with a certain hitch or a high rear, that's not the root. The high rear is not the root of the problem. There's other issues that could be involved to create that issue with these dogs.
Yeah, that's somewhere where I really would like to be more knowledgeable. So that's kind of like when I see you have certain people on, I try to listen. It's hard for me to watch podcasts, even though we do one ourselves. It's sometimes hard for me to sit down and watch them. But I definitely need to get more knowledgeable about, you know, everything. Like I say all the time, if you know, at these dog shows, if we had to answer the questions the junior handlers had to answer, I'd be in big trouble.
Right. You know?
Respect to all them young people, bro, because they really have to put in more work than we do, and I don't care what anybody says, you know.
That's a fact.
I've never had to do that ever since I started showing. Ain't nobody asked me. Either.
Bro, I probably wouldn't show if I had to do that.
Imagine if we didn't.
Oh, I think it's a good thing. Like I said, the more I get into it, the more knowledge, the more breeding coefficients testing I'm doing, more testing my dogs. Like, bro, when I first started, I literally just loved the dogs and loved to train dogs. Was like, damn.
Ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
How long have you been breeding for?
Man, see, man, you taking my – listen, this is an interview for Sunday.
Y'all come check our interview out Sunday, man.
Yo, bro, like I can't ask a question?
Yeah. I've been in the dog game probably 5 years. I don't really consider myself a breeder yet. I've only had four litters. Mm-hmm.
And what are you breeding?
I'm trying to get the breeding standards. I'm stuck in classic drive right now, bro.
Yeah, it'd be like that. You'll be all right. You'll figure it out.
Yeah, we're getting some better dogs, but when I came on, y'all were talking about, you know, kind of cutting down on numbers and stuff with dogs. I'm kind of going through that same thing, bro. I had 12 over here and I was like, bro, it's just, and even if they're a champion, like my first champion bitch, bro, I bred her one time and I took her to Waffle House. Waffle House is why I got in the game. That's kind of my style, you know, just to let y'all know that if you don't know.
We know, trust me.
But I want that on a bigger frame, obviously, now, because you know I wanna grow with the breed, I wanna grow with the ABKC and other registries as well. But you know, ABKC is where I started. I've had to get down, you know, some dogs and there, but like I said, I champed her and bred her to Waffle, which is a proven producer. Can't nobody take that from him. And you know, just didn't like what I got, and I'm not gonna breed her again. I mean, I'm not that type, and I'm also not the type that I don't want 50 champions over here. I want that motherfucker. Like I want that. If it ain't top 10, I really don't want to push. You know,
that's why I'm taking my time.
Yeah,
that's why I'm not rushing it. That's why people are like, where you at? Where you coming out with? Man, I'm good.
Well, look how long you killed it with shots for, man. It's hard to go back in there mediocre and half step, bro.
It's yeah, hard. I came in there with Pup Smoke, man, and she's I produced since shots fired. I produced two champions, and she's almost a champion. She only needs 40 points. You know what I'm saying? I could have showed Shot's daughter and champed her out, but that's not what the fuck I want to do. See, like, I don't want to do that shit. For example, I've been to nationals, bro. I've made the cut. Like, no, man. You know, I'm like a junkie. You know what I'm saying?
That's what differentiates people. Like, for example, like, I've told people that I've seen at shows, I've literally sat there and told them, like, yo, I looked at the dog that they brought, and I looked at them, and I said, you're better than this. Like, no, this is unacceptable, bro.
That's right.
Like, you understand? Like,
but people don't want to hear that.
If you're my peoples, because not everybody can hear that. You understand what I'm saying? If you're my peoples, like, yo, listen, like, I know you know that this is unacceptable. Yeah, you understand what I'm saying? Next show, oh, shoot, you brought something else different. Yeah.
That's right. Now we're talking.
You feel me? Like, it's like you said, like, he made national. He made the cut. Now he wants to come with better energy.
He needs that number one.
You understand? Like, yeah, hey, man.
You know what? I really don't care about number one.
Oh, yeah?
I really don't care about number one because we've been there already and I know if we showed the same amount of shows that the top five dogs were showing, we would have blew the fucking top dog out of the water.
Because you used to frustrate me so bad with that crap, bro. Especially when I was running Wayne, I was like, man, why don't this dude hit more shows so we can have more waffles in the top 10, bro? I was like, because this dude's sitting at number five and went to like six shows. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Nah, I went to three shows.
My point exactly. Like,
what year was this? 19?
I was top 10, what, 21 and last year, 22?
Man, I'm over here acting stupid.
Oh, you disconnected your shit?
Yeah.
What you say now?
I said it was 21 and 22 when you were slowing down on shots.
Yeah, because 2000, the middle of 2017, the whole 2018, 2019, and 2020. But I'm going to say before 2020, 2017, 18, and 19 is when the real competition was. Not saying there's no competition in the. I'm saying where there was. I'm talking about in the class, and just for the class shows, they had to break them up. 30, 40 dogs, champion class, 30, 50 dogs in the building. Grand champion class, you got like 15 grand champions.
I'm listening to you, but I'm also showing you my trophies.
I came into the show game in American Bully when the shit was real. Like, it was real.
Well, I'm gonna tell you this. I mean, and I'm not being negative any kind of way. It's changed since I started showing. You know, I said I've been showing for about 3 years, for probably 4 years. And, you know, when we were going, like you said, man, it was 30 dogs in the champion class, having to split the champion class into three different, you know, or two different classes. And I went to a show this weekend in Tennessee, man. It's just, I don't know, you know, if it's the economy and everything, because I know this year's been rougher on me than most, too. You know, I don't know if everybody else is feeling that or not.
It could be. It definitely could be.
I'm broke as shit.
But I think people are reloading right now. He said he's broke as shit. He's lying.
Man, I saw him stay broke.
So I think people are reloading right now. I don't think people are necessarily just not hitting shows. I think they just know what's required to hit these shows now and actually be the zeros and be these dogs that win nationals.
Can I tell you what I think?
What's up, man?
I think that people go to other registries sometimes. Mm-hmm. Because they require less than we do. And they push those registries. And they push those registries because that's where they're winning.
I don't agree. I would say that the judging, the integrity and everything of those other registries are ironclad. But the some of the things within it could be corrected, like the judges could be more informative, they could be more knowledgeable, they could be more asked of judges than to just put them in a ring because you know who they are, or you know they show but like you said they don't know why this dog walks with a hitch. They don't, like you said, you'll ask them why, and they wouldn't even know how to answer the question.
Oh, my man, bounce.
Yeah. It's all good.
No, that's fine, bro. I'm listening.
He got the link. If he wanted to come back in, he'd come back. Yeah. There he goes. I knew it was something.
Yeah, it's me trying to do too much on my phone. I'm not very good with the technology. But I've been to a lot of different registries. I've been to 5 different registries. We almost got Wayne champed out 5 different. I still say ABKC is where you beat your chest as far as competition and everything goes. The grand champion class this weekend was, man, pretty damn. It was pretty nice to see, man. You know, you had Hangman, you had Zeus, you had
No, that's a badass dog,
bro. Hey, you gonna be in North Carolina?
Who, me?
Lance, you coming to North Carolina the next month?
What's the date?
29th.
Oh, I got one the 22nd.
I think I'm putting shots in the ring. I haven't done it in a minute. I'm going to just show up and
man, see you're going to show up and you're not going to put him in the ring because you're going to be showing him off.
You're going to put him in the ring if he shows up with it.
He knows.
You know it.
Why shouldn't I?
I like him.
For what?
But I didn't bring Wayne this weekend either.
Why can't I shake the cobwebs off?
For what?
To get him ready for nationals.
Oh, you're gonna show him a nationals?
Yeah.
You didn't go last year, did you?
Nah.
Then yeah. You definitely gotta dust off the cobwebs then.
Yeah. Definitely. Yeah, he's coming to nationals.
Yeah, it's like Blue was a little rusty last year at nationals. It seemed like, you know.
Blue.
That's what I'm saying. People. Yeah.
That's an impressive dog. I like him.
Man, god dang, him and Zero both. And Samson too, you know. I just feel like
who do you like better? Who do you like better? Blue or Zero? And why?
Blue.
And why?
Headpiece pretty much. But I will say at the Nationals, Zero's rear had him, man. They had Zero on point. I got behind him to look at that Pacific point at Nationals. And I like Blue's head. I mean, I got a Zero daughter over here. So, I don't hate either one of them. You know, I don't have anything off Blue. I do have some Chaos stuff, but I don't have anything off Blue. Hangman's really impressive too, man. When he matures, he's going to be nice. His movement is stupid,
he's
bro.
A puppy, right?
I think he's like a month away from 2. So I think in the next year, he's going to be, he has potential to run for top 10, you know, again, next year, top 5 for sure. Cause he looked small out there this weekend though, bro. Next to Zeus and Logan had a big dog, a big brown dog. I should have got the name of it, but
it's not Caramala, right?
Oh, it may be. It's a brown dog, big brown dog.
Logan always has some stuff, oh man.
Yeah, I don't know if it was his or he's showing it for somebody. Yeah,
Logan. Hey, I remember the first time I met Logan was at the Allentown. That first Allentown show I seen you at, where you was like, "You all right, man?" When I ran up on him.
Oh. Yeah, you wild.
Yeah, I was wild when I first jumped in the dog game because it's honestly straight from the running the street world to now you know where a person say they gonna bust your head open or say something violently to you, you know, you ready to? It's like, hold up. Really?
Yeah.
All right. Now somebody see you at this show.
When I first met you, you still had a little bit of that fire left too. Now,
what you mean?
Nah. When he first came in, my man was like a rolling. I don't even know, bro. You know,
I wait till you go in the bathroom.
I know. You kind of had that. You kind of had that little vibe too, man. Somebody had you hot somewhere.
Who the fuck you Dota, Lance, seen you, bro. I seen you lose it at a show before. And I think it was, hold up, what show was it?
Shreveport.
I was about to say fucking Shreveport.
When, Dota, I, when, I, when, I, when, When I champed John Wayne out and I wasn't sure about the points, and dude was like, "Hey, bro, you need to go on and get out of the way." And I was like, "Bro, I know I done seen you. He said, "Hey, man, now that you know what a champion feels like, you need to get out of the ring." And I told him, I said, "Bro, there ain't a motherfucker. I'm not gonna say no names because they a judge now." But
I seen that shit. Yo, I was standing right there. I was like,
"Bro, nah, I ain't going nowhere."
Nah, I seen that shit, and I was just like,
I got a lock in that night over that dude called me, and he was like, "Man, I was standing behind you in the ring, and I know you're a no bullshit type of guy. I want to lock that dog in right now. I got a lock in over that shit."
Hey, I made everybody on the side laugh. Right, I said, "That motherfucker better be a defensive end, because that's a motherfucking Pro Bowl left tackle right there, boy." Everybody started laughing, boy, because, bro.
You know I played ball in college.
I can tell.
Man,
what you play, guard?
Surprise! What
you guard? I played with Patrick Willis and Mike Wallace and Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis, and all them boys.
You play defensive line?
Offensive line, left tackle, Ole Miss, tackle. Rebel.
See what I said? All right.
Yep.
So you play for Ole Miss?
Yeah, that's my hometown.
That's what I'm saying. Go Gators.
Yeah. Y'all beat us plenty of times. You learn to lose.
Man, listen, the first time I became a Gators fan, I moved to Jacksonville in the early 80s. And I seen Emmitt Smith in the Gator Bowl. I became a fan ever since then. My stepdad took me to the game, and I was just like, I just became a Gator fan. You know what I'm saying? And I remember the running back, and I was like, I want to be like him. And I remember my father saying, "Yeah, that's Emmitt Smith. He's going into the NFL one day. Watch." Good I think call, he was a Pops. Freshman or something like that.
Good call, Pops.
good call. He hit that one on the head. That dude's a beast, man.
So yeah,
I'm not even a Cowboys fan, and you can't help but give people like that respect, you know?
Yeah, fuck the Cowboys.
Yeah, for sure.
You got an Eagles fan up here? What NFL team do you fuck with?
You know, me being Ole Miss, I always pulled for the old Manning boys.
Oh, so you're a Colts fan?
Really Ole Miss players, like, DK Metcalf.
I got you,
those are the guys I try to root for now. You know, DK's from my hometown.
I'm thinking Tennessee, so I need to –
I do. I pull for Tennessee and stuff, you know.
But you said Ole Miss, and I wasn't thinking Tennessee. Who's that?
That's the CT son.
Okay.
That's an oldie.
Yeah, it's an
oldie. Yeah, man, that's me.
That's a big ass oldie, dude.
That's me, bro. I'm oldie.
Y'all put in who team y'all mess with, man, in the chat, man.
I'm an Eagles fan.
Who's y'all NFL team?
Who you want to go with, baby? I'll go with my old lady's team, the Dirty Birds, the Falcons. She's from Atlanta. I'll rock with them. I'm from Mississippi. We ain't got no team. I'm going to rock with Atlanta.
He turned his hat around. He's ready to go.
I know who he's rooting for.
Duval. Hey.
Right out of my mouth.
Yeah, let me try to go catch a game, bro.
Like what game?
You know, a professional football game. I think that's the only professional thing I ain't never been to.
No. I ain't never been to a game either.
Me either, bro. I don't know, I'll figure Jackson, but it don't matter to me since I don't really have a team. Try to catch one close.
We can possibly do a double banger where we can hit a show. And then the next day, we can go to a fucking game.
That would be dope. Tell Tom when he sets that new show up to set it up where it's.
Yeah, that'll be dope. But yo, see, the Jags won't be showing in the stadium then. They're getting a new stadium.
That's a nice bully.
Yeah, that's a nice one. That's a nice one. Where is she? That's a he or she?
Yeah, that's
a, where's that's he a at? He.
That's my little brimstone I have hiding.
How old is he?
Maybe two.
Nice.
I'm about to say two, a year and a half, too. He still look like a little baby a little bit.
Yeah, I feel like I got my best pop from between two and three.
I appreciate this bad.
Man.
Bro. Of course. Hey. I got to have a picture of him.
Nice.
Look at this weirdo over here. Look at that weirdo.
Who's that?
That's Mr. Exotic right there.
Yeah, that's him.
That's our guy right there. Hold on.
Is that the one that just had the baby with what's her name?
See, like for example, like look, now look, this is me. This is me and my dog. Like,
that's right? You handling?
Yeah, that's me handling with my little comfortable boots. Now where you go?
What like, what year was that?
Stupid loaded in the front. Stupid loaded in the front. Lacks angulation. He is what he is. You understand what I'm saying? Right. He is what he is. He ain't perfect, but it's not a bad starting point.
No, that's a nice dog.
Not bad at all.
Yeah, the headpiece is what I'm trying to figure out over here.
The headpiece, that's not hard. That's easy.
Yeah, I think I was showing a female this weekend. I co-own her with somebody, and you know, body wise on a female, man, you really couldn't ask for much better. She's a touch high in the rear, but her headpiece, bro, is just American Pit Bull Terrier, and it's like, you know, and even the judges, they're like, Lance, her head. And I was like, you already know, I know, but you know,
it's hard though. Headpiece isn't hard.
No, it's not.
Headpiece is one breeding. You're
good. And you know what's hard?
What do y'all recommend? I mean, like, how do y'all sound really confident in that? Like
find a headpiece you like.
And not just that. Not just that. Look for a headpiece that you like, but make sure that's a stamp in that line. You know what I'm saying?
Like a Rocco headpiece or something.
Or like that Magoo type shit, you know, where they have that certain type of round teddy bear type look head.
See, I figure, see, because this bitch I'm talking about is zero bred to muscle tone, which is bred to Casablanca, which, you know.
Maybe it's too much. Maybe you need to do an outcross.
Too much of it. No, what's ending up happening is people keep lining these dogs up.
And yeah, you need to
understand
that
you double up on the good. So you're getting the good body, but you're getting...
You got to do an outcross, man.
So you don't think going back with some more Rocco would be the way to go?
No. Fuck. Get totally out of that shit right there. Come back to that. Don't look at it as a dead end, right? You definitely can, because you're going to need that. You're going to need that. It's not a roadblock.
At some point, you have to understand that you have to breed the dog in front of you.
That's right.
Period.
And that's kind of the road I was headed down. I was kind of breeding, you know, because I didn't know anything, y'all. Like, I mean, we raised boxers and stuff coming up, but, like, I got my dogs to run and go in the woods and just be, you know, dogs. And man, like I said, I've only had four litters, but I've learned in them four litters. I need some better dogs.
You know, I think people don't understand.
Whoever you got – I'm sorry to cut you off, Joel.
No,
like, whoever you got your first dog from – like, he shouldn't have let you, like, you shouldn't have been, like...
Oh, bro, for sure. Like, it was like, a fuck like, situation.
Nobody should have bit me. Like, nobody should have sold you a dog and not guided you as to, all right, bro, what exactly do you want? What is it that you need? Okay.
Oh, no, bro, this was, like, complete opposite. Like, yeah, bro, but that's a bad deal.
But that's the problem with the community. Everybody wants to make a quick buck.
Yep.
You understand? So as soon as somebody comes hungry... It's like wolves, bro. Like
they take advantage of it.
Come to me. Yeah,
just look at a post. Go say. Make a post and say, "Yo, I'm looking to breed to. I got a female in heat right now, but I only got $300. Watch how many people hit your ass up,
bro. We're from Mississippi. I've seen people offer deer legs and shit for puppies and shit, bro.
I'm talking about people that you would never expect hit you up. I might do that shit to get me a deal on a stud or some shit like that.
No, I'll just play.
I ain't gonna do it. But what I think people make a mistake with dogs that come in from other breeds is these breeds been established, so they're fucking on autopilot. If you're gonna make a mistake, you really gotta fuck that. You really gotta do some fucked up shit to make this dog look like it's
fucking up.
You know what I'm saying? You really gotta do something messed up for this dog to not look like what it was put on here 500 years to do. You know what I'm saying? 300, whatever. So when they come into the American Bullies, it's not on autopilot. No, because you can breed to what you think is in front of you, but if you don't know what's behind your ass too, you're gonna get hit upside the head.
Yeah, but that's why I say. That's
you got to know both sides. It's a balance with everything.
See, like, all right. So, like, I disagree.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that pet breeding is the right thing to do. Me personally, that's okay. Just my personal opinion. So I've
said, you breed strictly on Pheno?
Yes. So I've always said breed the dog in front of you until the dogs behind the dog in front of you were produced by you.
That's
the only way that you're gonna know what's there.
I don't agree, bro. That's why I love you so much.
And I'm telling you this because that's the way that I bred oldies. Oldies is a composite breed of dog. So mm-hmm. meaning, for example, what it looks like at a couple of weeks old isn't what it looks like in a couple of months. And it isn't what it looks like from 6 months to 9 months. It just pulls from such a huge gene pool because it's still an open stud breed. It pulls from so many, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I said breed it. Breed the dog that's in front of you. And it's going to take you longer, but I don't know. That's me. That's how I've always done it, and that's how I'm going to continue to do it. And I'm breeding bullies now.
I don't know if the dog in front of me is the bear. I don't know. No disrespect, but I don't know if the dog in front of me is the bear. You feel what I'm saying? But the dog looks so good. The dog is an anomaly. The dog is you look at that dog and you say, yo, I want a fucking dog. I'm breeding a dog in front of me. How many people said that? I'm going to breed the dog in front of me and got straight.
But then they
not stop. American bullies. Yeah, why? Why though? Why? That's you're just saying then they stop. But how many years does that push a person's program back when they do a fucked up breeding when they mess up? You right. But this is what I'm saying. Why you don't make moves like that?
Yeah, but
because you don't know what's behind that dog. That can
you and I both know that.
I seen it plenty of times, not just that dog.
Sadly.
Not just that dog. I've seen it happen plenty of times.
The pedigree is only worth as much as the paper on it.
Listen, that's what I'm saying, man. I'd rather go to something where I'm in a safe zone right now. Uh-huh. I feel like I'm in a safe zone where anybody messed with something with these dogs, that had to be years down the line. It's not within the last 10, 15 years. Well, 10, 12 years. Mm-hmm. It has this. I ain't gonna say 12. I only been in the game maybe 8. So yeah, maybe 10 years. This line hasn't been messed around with. I can say that because I can see the consistency within the pedigree. But that's what I'm saying. I've seen dogs. If you go too deep into breeding, you can see these dogs, the fucked up dogs, present themselves that were bony. You think that they're gonna be boned up dogs if 4 or 5 times this? Nope. They're gonna lose muscle type.
When you start getting into 4, 5, 6 times this, people don't understand.
That's why I don't do that shit. Neither.
Just like you're doing that to double up on the good, you also double up on the bad.
On the bad. That's the same thing if you breed to a dog in front of you. No. Not double up on it, but not double up on it. I get what you're saying. But see, this is what the outcross is for, though.
Well, yeah. I mean, like, you'll see over time exactly how I'm going to do what I'm going to do. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm letting these dogs mature. You know, this has always been a hobby for me. I've never depended.
Whatever. It's been a hobby. He's won nationals once.
I know. No shit.
And his fucking wife won nationals 2 times.
I swear to you, bro. I swear to you. If I'm lying, let somebody come on here and tell me I'm lying.
You know, hey, man.
It's a hobby for me too, bro.
It's a hobby for me. I don't live off of it. It's a hobby for me as well. I'm in the red fucking with these dogs. You know, man.
And to the people that make money off of it, bro, more power to you.
Because I'm trying to get like y'all.
I'm trying to get like y'all.
Well, you know, since y'all you won nationals and all of, and both of you guys got way more show experience.
That thing don't mean nothing. I haven't won nationals, and man, if I don't, man, that don't mean nothing.
Man, that's a man.
What year did you win?
Mm-hmm. See, he's full of shit. You see that?
But I'm just saying. But like, still, he like,
tough fault, man. Come on, bro.
Shit, it's a hobby to me. It's one of the only hobbies I see that could actually maybe pay for, you know, at least break even, maybe one day, you know.
One day. But that's if you do the right thing, right?
But I spent like 20 plus grand a year when I was trying to stay top 10.
Oh, bro. I think I showed somebody my receipts.
I quit keeping up with them.
I kept up with it. It was 2016 when I campaigned Hov. Bro, I think that we stopped counting at 30 something for $1.
I believe
that's
it, bro.
That's the year I came in again.
That includes the gas, the travel, the hotels, the show,
the booth, the food, $80. Bro. I mean, hell, you look at just booth and entry fees, you're over 200.
Bro, I was coming from Rhode Island.
That's crazy.
We're like 3 hours away from Maine, bro. So you know what I'm saying? We're like fucking close to Canada around this bitch. You know what I'm saying?
Northeast is a motherfucker. Yeah.
Me and Nick too.
Joel, remember you were just telling a story about how when you went to North Carolina, I didn't win anything?
Oh, bro, I was so fucking mad. All of that traveling, all of those hours, and the ride back was so beautiful.
Listen. Oh, wow. I did the same thing. The same thing happened.
Beautiful, man.
I was campaigning for Top Dog. I was in the running still. So I left work, jumped in a car with one of my dogs, I can't remember, and drove all the way to Arkansas. Or Arkansas, whatever, right? I went over there, showed, didn't win a thing, bro. Like, bro. I'm talking about, I didn't even make it on my class, bro. Mind you.
Not today, motherfucker.
I was kicking ASS all last season, bro. You feel me? Like, I just, bro. So then it came time for me to leave, and I remember that Jerry and Chris wouldn't let me leave. They made me stay. They made me go to sleep, and I slept 4 to 5 hours before I got on the road because I had to get back in order to get to work back on Monday on time.
All right. So
that was a very sucky.
This is why
I think we've all driven those. You know those.
Not all, because I've been complaining about those 6 hour trips. I'm like, what,
bro? Trust me.
When you're that top 10, man, I remember we went 8 weekends in a row, bro, and went all the way to Virginia and then went to Padre Island.
Hey, Lance, I was a DJ, right? When did DJs usually work? Friday and Saturday, right?
Thank you, baby.
Bruh, I was DJ on Friday night.
And ball up.
Then leave there, have maybe like 2 hours sleep and drive 15 hours, 12 hours.
Nah, bro, we did it. We, bro, I put in my.
That's why it helps to have a team, bro. That's why it helps to have a team and travel with the team as one of our main reasons of starting the BWO and stuff, you know? Like,
hell no, bro. I rock that shit on myself, big.
There you go.
I rock that shit on myself. Hey, soldier,
are we going to act like we don't see us on the screen right there? Tina Moore, for example, you could take Blue and Zero pedigree. Is inconsistent and Zero's pedigree is pretty much consistent, but I think they both throw pretty good offspring, so I get what he's saying.
Does somebody have their peds?
Nah, I don't, but you're saying is it's
chaos, son.
If I'm breeding a dog, mm-hmm. I understand what he's saying too. What Tina said, you're saying. I can understand that, but I just know how many years you throw down the drain if you do one bad breeding. I'd rather do one bad calculated breeding than one fucking successful breeding that I didn't calculate to a dog that's a fucking out. That's a scatter breeding. Sorry. My brain was gone.
I'd rather do
an inconsistent breeding that I thought in my head that was going to go good because I seen what was going on. And I can factor in, you know what? Yeah, I fucked up because of this. I can probably put it together why it didn't work out at the end of the day. But I'd rather do that than to produce dogs that I don't know what's behind them. I don't know what's supporting them because that's going to pop up. And I don't want to be the person that just produces one good dog or two good dogs out of a litter. No, I want to have consistent.
Listen. I'm sorry.
We're way past that right now in this game. American Bullies is way past that.
I'm not.
I'm definitely past that. People should know that.
Listen, bro, I'll be honest with you. I'm just getting my feet wet with the breed.
Well, I'm at the point where I can have three consistent dogs in an 8 or 10 puppy litter because I'm already working with a line. Look at what we're already working with. Look at what we already got in mixture within what we're doing. You know what I'm saying? All of us went separate ways, but then we joined at some kind of way at the back end. Some breedings didn't work out, but man, the breedings that I did just by being within Dirty Gang and Duval Bullies was a blessing. You know what I'm saying? Because I wouldn't have Pup Smoke right now, and I wouldn't have Sage. Those are my two. I know what's behind those dogs, and they look the part. So now all I have to, that's why I'm speaking from doing it. I'm not speaking on just, I've done the same shit that people that you were talking about. I'm not doing that shit again. That shit pushed me back.
I'll be honest with you, bro. I don't see.
I'm not doing it again.
I don't see myself doing it any other way. And the only reason is because, and I'm not being arrogant by any means, bro. Like, I see myself doing it the way that I'm telling you because ain't nobody done it like the way that I'm going to do it. That's the way that I look at it. Like,
Jerry James talks about that.
I love that info, bro. He does coefficiency breed.
I had him on my show. He does the coefficiency testing. So for dogs,
is he saying inbreeding coefficient matter for consistency?
Yes.
What is he saying, that inbreeding is necessary for consistency?
No, there's a certain number.
It's a test that he runs. It goes back so many generations and sees how many dogs are in that ped, how many times, which, you know, is pretty much just breaking the ped down. Yep.
For real? Like, y'all really doing all that to breed?
I started. Yeah, I'm trying to. Yeah, I'm trying to do as much education as I can.
Why not? Why? I don't want to wear bell bottoms. You know what I'm saying? And butterfly neck collars. You know what I'm saying? I want to. Like, I'm like, fuck that shit, man. You know what I'm saying?
What does that mean?
That's some old school shit. That's old school shit. That's too old school, man. You know what I'm saying? Fuck that. No, I know disrespect. This is just
reading. Damn, bro. Like, I don't know, bro. I'm
going to let him explain it to you.
So you strictly just for real just breed what's in front of you, Julio. Like
100%, bro. 100%. Now, don't get me
wrong. You don't agree like a 50-50 relationship would be good?
I'll give you an example, okay? I'm not going to say who it is. I'm not going to do this, that, and the third, all right?
I just sent you the link.
So, for example, like somebody purchased a dog, all right? They like the dog. They like the look. They had a female. I guided them to breed that female that they had accordingly.
I got you, Nick.
To line them up for the dog that they got off of me. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
So now, both of those litters, he can line breed to the dog that he got off of me. And he's going to have consistency. From that point on, I will guide
Go ahead.
I will guide him into breeding each dog that he picks, whatever his pick is, accordingly. You understand? Because he already did his line breeding, so now he has to outcross or else he's going to get stuck in. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, for sure. And that's something like I call it like kind of breeding yourself in a corner. Exactly. You know, I think that's very important, but like still at the same time, if you're just breeding the dog in front of you, do you still like look at the ped and kind of like, hey, I'm heading in this direction, like
That's the point. Three. Breed the dog in front of you until you know the dog's behind the dog in front of you. The point is to create your own pedigree so you know what you have going on. You know exactly what's in a dog. You know why you bred that dog to this dog in order to continue your thing from this, that, and the third. That's the way that it should be. That's the way that a program should be run, in my opinion. Yeah. I don't think that you should be looking back at dogs that you haven't seen. I don't think that you should look back at dogs that you haven't touched.
I don't look back just because of the dogs you could see. I look back because there's a certain look that I want, a certain quality that I want as well.
I'm not disagreeing with you. I understand the logic as to why you breed that the way that you breed. I can 100% mm-hmm. understand. I have this conversation with Anthony Gonzalez. He's a big pet guy. He'll go back 15, 16, 17 years off the top of his head, bro.
I don't think the pet is that important to the look. that's why I went to a ped that had a certain look, or I made a certain decisions to move towards a certain ped that has this certain look to achieve this. So I want both of best worlds. I don't want just, I understand what you're saying, but I can do the same thing. But that takes more time. While there's both to breed a consistent dog on your end, while that might take a long while, versus me having that, me knowing the dogs that's behind the dog that I'm breeding might take a certain amount of time.
Less time is what you're saying.
No, it could take the same amount of time. You know what I'm saying? It could take this one can supersede the other one. Not saying, not giving one any weight.
All right, bro.
Just saying one can supersede the other one. Oh, I'm sorry. First, introduce yourself, Jerry, and please explain this coefficiency breeding. I'm gonna put my mic on mute.
Please. Oh, okay. This is the guy. Yes.
Yeah, I'm gonna put my mic on mute.
What's up, guys? Yeah, Jerry James, Dubtown Bullies. Basically, Wright's coefficient of inbreeding has been used for like 100 years. It was developed in 1923, if I remember right. The guy was the head of the USDA, and they basically started it for cows. But so each dog, right, has 73 chromosomes, and on those chromosomes, they have loci, which contain the traits for individual dogs. And so by doing a coefficient of inbreeding, which gives you basically, it looks at the total number of dogs. The program I have uses 10 generations, and it gives you a mathematical equation that tells you how much inbreeding is contained in your trial mating of the dogs that you're looking at breeding. And so what it's just a predictor, right, of risk and probability in terms of being able to take those particular dogs and fix those traits. It's a good way to basically provide consistency, a consistent look in your program, gives you an indication of when you need to outcross. I've mentioned before, there's nothing wrong with scatter breeding. It does serve a purpose, but I'm of the opinion that strictly breeding phenotype, while it may be very good for genetic diversity, which I support, provides unpredictable results.
But at some point, as long as you continue to keep what you're producing and you continue to use it in your program, at some point it doesn't become scatterbred anymore.
Well, that's true. If you're line breeding and you're fixing those traits, then no, it does not become scatterbred anymore.
So when I sit there and I say breed the dog in front of you, it's obviously with a purpose. The purpose is for you to get the best out of your breeding and then somehow incorporate it into what you have. I mean, obviously, you're just not doing one breeding in your program. You should be doing 2, 3, 4 breedings at a time.
Yeah, but when, you know, it's important to breed the dog in front of you, but it's also important to understand the genetic makeup of that dog and the pairing as well. If you like specific traits of that dog, right, then
so
what
you
want
to
do is pair it up with
something.
I had no
idea that what you're saying existed. Thank you. You educated me on it. So now, cool. For example, like my reasoning as to saying what I say is because I haven't seen these dogs in person.
Yeah.
I really don't know how these dogs have been bred.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? So I'm going to breed the dog in front of me until the dogs behind the dog in front of me were produced by me.
And who
breeding for certain trades.
And I can understand where you're coming from, because there's a lot of bullshit within the game too, where you don't know what is what. Like you said, I don't know if this pedigree is real. I don't know if this shit's real.
We don't know if your paperwork's right.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
But it's all good. I got them, like you said, I got the dogs in front of me, and the same person that I decide to breed, like I bred the Kodak Black. I see that dog in front of me, but you know what? It's a better risk, and I got what I wanted.
All that matters, bro. As long as you're getting what you want, and however it is that you're doing it, continue doing what you're doing, man.
And my bad, Nick. This Nick Angry Inc. of Duval Bullies. Go ahead, man, and chime in, fam.
I'm just listening. I'm just learning right now, bro. I had shit to say earlier, but Yella left.
You always got something to say.
Yella left. He departed.
Oh, you
so Julio, when you say breed the dog in front of you to the dog behind, you know, or what you produce, what do you kind of
better wording for that?
No. I mean, I understand what you're saying, but like, what are you?
You're still gonna need the line to get to that.
You're still gonna need the line breed, but you're doing it forward.
You're not doing it backwards this time. Exactly. You're doing it forward.
You're not line breeding on stuff that you don't know.
You know how many conversations me and this dude has had? I know what, like,
what I'm saying. That's why I'm saying that you should have a couple of them. You should be doing a couple of breedings with a couple of different studs and then picking the best out of the best, which you like in each trade, and then trying to bring it all together.
That's when it's really not autopilot. That's when it's really one dog out of the litter.
And then after you do that, you should start seeing a little bit more consistency. You understand what I'm saying? And slowly, it's going to take you some time, bro. But if you really want to develop your line, you really want to develop your look, you like your thing, you don't want to sit there and be like, oh, it's two times this and the mom is this and the dad is off for this. And it, like, bro, like at some I don't want to say that.
So, Ray, the reason why he's saying that,
I'm like,
the reason why he's saying that you can't breed, he's not saying you can't. He's saying he wouldn't because he knows there's a lot of saltiness mixed in the pedigrees, right?
No, you can. Who's this? Ray Wilson.
As DCB Ray. That's my boy. He's good people right there.
Why can't you breed the dog in front of you that also has pedigree behind? I mean, yo, bro, if you have the dog and you trust in the pedigree, bro, by all means, go do it. I'm just telling you.
Especially if you've seen the dog, just like he said. Especially if you've seen the dog.
Yo, what to do or anything. I'm just telling. I'm not going to tell you something that I wouldn't do.
It's pretty much. You want me to tell you what I do? I want to see what that male produces, right? Then what he produces, I want to see what the breeding program. I want to see what's going on. I want to see what he produced, like tone. Like you can watch what the hell he's doing. To Nick, you can watch what the hell they're doing, and it's like, yeah, have they messed up certain breeders? Yeah, they have.
Can everybody share this?
Yeah, please share this.
Take your time out and share this, guys.
Yeah, share this, man. I like it, please.
Because I think that this is very knowledgeable, man.
So, I forgot what the hell I was at, man.
You were telling us, my man left. You were telling us about
Lost Lands. Basically, how you're watching.
Oh yeah, so I watched people create, and then I decide if I want to sprinkle a little sauce in the game with Magoo and World Star to Waffle House to get Pup Smoke. You know what I'm saying? So I watched that dog
has produced a lot of dogs, a lot of nice
dogs. I watched it, and that takes time. But you know what comes behind that time? Consistency. So I watched what was going on, and I said, you know what? I have the same blood, and I can do the same type breeding, but I have different blood that adds certain traits that's positive into this. That basically tie into the negative as well. You know what I'm saying?
Change it up a little bit.
Yeah. You have to be creative.
You can see waffle kids out there and be like, that's a waffle kid. Like, that's a Rocco this. Or that. That's, I want it to be like, hey, that they got the,
okay.
They I don't want to be that no
Blue
more.
Magic Bully.
What?
I don't what want that shit no more. I want to be the one that people say that's a British dog.
What about the dog makes you
that's what I'm saying.
Go ahead, Julio.
Say that again.
What about the dog? Makes you say that's a waffle kid.
Well, like you can just like the traits, like you can see in their face. I mean, my boy, you can clearly tell a lot of his offspring, you know, I'm like, hey, you know, like before I walk up to him, you know, like, hey, that dog's got a waffle look to it, you know, to me, you know, because like I said, waffle's the first one.
My favorite waffle kid is that dog. What the heck is that name, dog? Tiny.
That's Shot's brother.
That motherfucker is bad.
Who owns him? Tommy?
Tommy Sorrow.
Yeah, that's a
bad I like dog. Tommy. Tommy's cool as fuck.
One thing we can't forget about too, though, you know, is the female. We like to talk about the stud all the time, but the female is super important as well.
I don't think we're leaving it out. I don't think we're leaving that out. I think we're keeping it all together because, and that's good to clarify it to let everybody know. Thank you, Jerry. And I think people should know it's not about just the male. You know, we've been speaking as a total one body. We're not separating nothing. But I think what we are separating is that you can breed with pedigree and you can breed with the look at the same time. You can reach both. Well, you can achieve both.
You have to do both.
Mm-hmm.
You just really you have to consider three factors, right?
Yeah, you need to outcross
the genetic makeup of the dog or the inbreeding coefficient, you know, or his genetics, the way the dog looks, because first of all, if the dog doesn't look like his breeding, then obviously you wouldn't want to use him, right? And then you want to look at his, you know, if he's a dog that's been breeding for a while, obviously you want to consider his productions. You know, that kind of thing. So they're really, you know, using just one factor, even like just using coefficient of inbreeding. While I focus a lot on that, that's not the only thing that I use. Phenotype is very important, right? So you really got to use all three.
Just you as definitely important. Do. But if you're trying to achieve your own look, you have to go down a beaten path that's your own. So, yeah.
Correct.
And that takes taking two dominant traits, just for me, two dominant traits, two dominant looks, and clashing them together and seeing what you're coming up with. Is it going to be failure? If you fail, cool. You tried. Now you can try to put risk. You can exactly. It's I'd rather fail on a calculated risk than on a whim. You know what I'm saying?
You might get one or two out of 10 and you take those and then you move and you breed those for it and you get more consistent as you go.
Right.
That's the beauty of it, in my opinion.
But if I do have one dog in the whole litter, if I only have two dogs in that litter, right?
I'm cool with that.
I'm cool. Exactly. Because I know where to move forward with these two dogs. But I know what can pop up though.
I breed for what I want. You understand what I'm saying? So if I do a breeding and I get one badass puppy, cool. I ain't there yet with what I got going on, but there's one puppy's gonna the next piece to my puzzle. You understand what I'm saying? Like, dude, I've done breedings for adult males that I have currently. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I've tried to produce a puppy for my adult males that I have. So I did a breeding based on my adult male's weakness.
That's why I did pup smoke for the shots fire breeding.
I don't know everything, bro, but I think I know a little bit.
Man, you know it, man. You know a lot, bro. What are you talking about? It's just
you breed for more extreme dogs, Nick.
No. I'm saying I seen Julio put up posts before, like this breeding that I'm doing is not for, or maybe it might have been a conversation that we had, but. This breeding that I'm doing right now, this was a few years ago, but he was like, this is not for show dogs.
It was probably brute stock, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
Like, people don't do that. Everybody that breeds is breeding for show dog. Bro, So, for example, like,
I'm breeding for a program.
In my oldie program, I have females that are ugly as shit, bro. Like, I'm talking about, like, their rears, their assembly, the thickness, certain things about them, I keep them around for
that. They bring to the table.
I need to breed them and replace them.
Hey, Nick.
Based on rears.
Understand
what I'm saying? Because rears are, in the oldie breed, rears is something that's very, they lack a lot.
Yeah, few and far in between.
You understand? They lack a lot. Narrow. So
Pup Smoke's mother was a tool. Nick seen her. Pup Smoke's mother, it was a straight breeding.
So what I'm trying to say is that you should also have, when I sit there and I say you should be breeding here, you should be breeding here, you should be breeding here.
Yeah.
You should be setting yourself up for, you understand what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Bro, this is a game. This is fun. And this is why people need mentors, bro. If I'm being honest, this is why people need mentors so that conversations like this could be having private conversation like this could be done this, that, and the third. People can grow. People
this is why this platform is here. This is why this platform is here.
Because everybody's looking for this.
This is why the platform. This is why the platform is here, because all of us love the breed. All of us love these dogs. We're not in it. We're in the red, man. We're like, you know what I'm saying? We're in it. We're in it for I'm in it for the legacy.
I'm in it forever.
My name. Y'all gonna remember my name when I'm gone.
You know what I'm saying? So definitely, I'm. God damn it.
Yo, son, I'm finally getting busy. So you gotta give me a minute.
The kids are asleep. Oh yes,
Mississippi finally became legal for medical. So I just got my license about a month ago, y'all. It was a dream come true.
Shit, Virginia
told me that in Guatemala it's like very illegal to have this.
Oh yeah,
all right, Eddie, yeah. This is the longest, but I know there's some shit in here. I just did it with Ricochet. Them puppies he got bad.
To Julio's point, my kennel partner owns. I was line breeding all along to try and continue to chase the look I was looking for, and I created badass bulls, but not quite what I wanted. But this outcross at this point, of course, puppies being so young, but at least they're legit bulls. There's no signs of sniping muscles. When you put those two dogs side by side, I knew it was going to hit me. Yeah, bro.
That's because you outcross the Lance. You see what he said? That's what you need to take an example of. The road he went, that's what you need to do.
It is right. And it isn't, though.
Yo, Lance, send me a number.
Hold up.
Give me a number.
On Eddie's head there, if you go back far enough, you're going to run into...
I'm going to do it when we get off the podcast, bro. Every time I touch a button, I leave this bitch.
All right, hey, let's listen what Nick got.
Yo, if you leave again, we're not letting you back in, son.
Hey, let's listen what Nick got to say. Go ahead, Nick.
Hey, Nick, I'm sorry, Nick.
No, you're good. If you go back far enough in Eddie's ped dad, that when you come off of Ricochet, and I want to see you go back to his grandfather, you're coming to Revy. And Revy is Miyagi Budamate brother. So breeding that China boy in, like, that's how I got my fucking head.
It's the outcross. Telling you, man.
Like, everybody's like, how'd you get that headpiece? You know what I mean? Like, my females carry that headpiece like Waffle, you know, a little more snipey. But my males, all my males off that litter have
you bonkers say, did you say your females carry a headpiece like what?
Like a very, very Waffle look, a little bit more snipey in the muggle. You know what I'm saying? Marshall, Larry. The other two brothers, they have big, massive heads, and that comes off the back of Marge, which is your G2 bloodline, so that's where I'm getting that headpiece, that super cheeky look and that short-ass muzzle from.
Yeah, I'm not doing all that. All that stuff that Nick has and knows, yeah, I'm not. Nope, that's not me, bro.
But here's the thing.
What I'm saying? I'm being
here's the thing.
No, I'm not being disrespectful at all, say, I'm listening.
But to compliment what you say, Julio, if you know the ped, I know the ped because of the fact that the dude who I bought my dog from had these dogs on his yard, right? And if he didn't have the dogs on his yard, then I would just be looking at a pedigree not knowing for a fact that this is what this dog carried, right? And this is what's in this dog's pedigree. I know it because I was there. I seen it with my own two eyes. So breeding the dog in front of me and also breeding off the pedigree, you know, I had flaws on Marge. I couldn't win for shit with her in the ring. But when I put her to Waffle, you know, I started smacking it with him, you know, Marshall, the brothers, the sisters.
Hey, Eddie, them dogs look like Revy, too. I ain't gonna lie to you. Them dogs got a little Revy in them.
What?
The litter that he had?
Yeah.
They look fucking.
Jerry just said something, man.
They look extreme, bro, like fucking Revy did when he was a puppy.
So it's not so much of an outcross.
Not Revy, but the puppies that Revy produced.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Mixed with what you got.
A lot of their brothers and sisters.
So you wasn't just chasing nothing, Eddie. What happened was a light came on. Like all of us happens. We were up on Team Alpha, Team this or Team that. Until we fucking learn. Until we fucking breed ourselves into a fucking corner. No disrespect to Waffle House. We're just keeping it real right here. So
Waffle shit kills it.
I seen Nick do it. with my own fucking eyes. So I'm not going to sit up here and sugarcoat nothing. And Tone even told him, don't do that shit. He told him, don't do it.
I was trying to do something.
He was trying to do something different.
Read that fucking mail that I sold.
And he told him, don't do it. So disclaimer was put up, right? Because Tone knew what he was talking about. So a light came on, just like all of us, and say, you know, Outcross, man. This shit been in my face for what, 5-6 years? And I've been fucking around. And it's happened to Nick. It's happened to Jerome.
That we had?
Nah, we were talking about an inbreed of me and you. We was talking. I'm totally past that, man. I tried to get it out of my system. So I'm on the rail right now. But I did it so it's something on the back end, though. It wasn't something in my program where it was like, you know what I'm saying? Raw. You know, I'm pushing myself back. It was something on the back end.
Let me throw something at you.
Don't throw it too hard.
Yeah. All right. So of all the analysis that I have done, if you go back, so, you know, there's a thing called the ancestor loss coefficient that my reports do, right? And it basically is a measurement of unique ancestors that remain after so many generations. So the average ancestor loss coefficient of these dogs after 10 generations is only about 20%. So if you really want to think about it, we're almost all breeding the same damn dogs, except for what we're trying to do is increase the probability of certain traits.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, we're all basically breeding the same blood in different combinations and trying to lock in those specific traits, you know, by increasing the probability that will happen.
So we might as well start doing what Julio said.
What I'm saying is that's where understanding the inbreeding coefficient comes into play.
All right.
We all got the same ingredients. It's how we chef it up.
Exactly.
What was
so you increase your probabilities by concentrating your genetics.
Is it the best dogs off that bloodline that you're breeding into your program, or is it the pet home dogs on that bloodline that you're breeding into your program? I think that's where like the big, you know, the big difference comes in.
If you're breeding, and look, I'm not saying that backyard dogs aren't great dogs. There are a bunch of dogs out there that have never seen a show ring that are great dogs. Oh, but if you're breeding, you know, if you're a serious breeder, in my opinion, and you're not breeding dogs that have, you know, champion, grand champion pedigrees and things like that, it's not so much about the title. It's about the fact that they've been in front of numerous judges and they've been evaluated, right? I mean, that's what's important. I don't so much care about the title. The title just represents the fact that they've been consistently evaluated and ranked as a superior dog in terms of their
height. Nah, man, I disagree with that. I disagree to the judges,
should be telling y'all the dogs that win are the dogs that should be bred.
To the outside, to the outside looking in, that it might seem like that, but when we got the dogs in the show ring, I want to bust. I know this dog's coming there. It's competitive. It's more than these titles mean. More than just oh, my dog's just been evaluated. Nah, it's the heat of the battle, what we've been through with certain top dogs, or we're trying to fight certain dogs and get to these. Yeah, and certain handlers we're trying to overachieve, and we're trying to do certain things. So it's more than just to the outside people. Yeah. That's what it means. You know what I'm saying? But to us, to us, that championship, that championship that Nick has with a dog that he produced and went in the ring and won it with means totally different than just the dog that's just been evaluated. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, I don't disagree with you there, brother. I'm not trying to minimize the achievement.
No. I'm just saying it for clarity for people that's listening, so they don't take it that way.
It's just that dog has been through the gamut of several different people that are knowledgeable and evaluated that dog and awarded it based on, or now we don't always agree on what, you know, how the dog's been awarded, that kind of thing, but at least versus a backyard dog. And I'm not saying backyard dogs are bad, but it's just, you know, showing your dog gives validation as to whether or not that's honestly that whether that's a breeding quality dog or not. My opinion.
We're listening, but we're also reading.
Yeah, I think it. I think you need to see. People don't understand. People, not saying you, Mr. Trimmer. I'm not saying you, but I don't think people understand that these ain't dead ends. Just because you bred yourself into a corner and you have this dog that you wanted to breed to that is gonna make it three or four times, but the light came on because somebody talked to you about this certain situation, and you start to understand breeding. It happens to all of us, but you always can come back to that dog that you had in mind. It doesn't have to be a dead end because you're going to need dogs like that in 2, 3, 4 years down for the daughter, granddaughter, great-granddaughter. You're going to need dogs like that to come back to.
Yeah, and it's not hard to get out. It's not hard to get out of a corner.
Right. Definitely not.
Bob and weave, Obi.
You have to. You know what I'm saying?
You can buy a stud credit.
Rope-a-dope.
Hey, look, bro. I appreciate you having me on, man. I'm gonna get off here. It's the early morning for me, bro.
We're gonna have Lance Lee. We're gonna have Lance Lee from BW on BWO on here Sunday at 9 p.m. We're gonna not take too much of his time. Have him on an hour and a half, hopefully. You know what I'm saying? And we're gonna rock out.
Hey, I appreciate it. See y'all guys. Y'all have a good one.
All right. You have a blessed one. Yep. Yeah, man.
Oh,
so.
Damn. Oh damn! I got a close up of Julio smoking.
And Jerry, look at Jerry. Looked like he had like 5 shots today. His eyes glow because I know you don't smoke.
I've only had 3 drinks.
See, I was close. I was close, and he about to have another one because we smoking. He's like, I can't smoke, but guess what?
Yeah, I don't smoke, but I drink.
I'm gonna have one of these. Goddamn it!
I smoke.
Yeah, right.
So
I drink.
Who and Bernard said he said most of your top dogs are scattered bred. That's cool.
I don't know, that's
cool, man. Guys,
well, you know what? You know why they are, guys. So when like Zero and Blue, right? They're outcrosses. So you get that outcross vigor, right? That influx of genetic material, you get those special dogs, but that doesn't automatically mean they're going to be great breeding dogs.
Facts. Oh. But that's why you have to, that's why it's good to know both sides is on point with that. That absolutely. They breed a consistent look. Like, that they breed a certain look.
If I owned either one of those dogs and I had a plan to do what they did with those dogs, because that was a well thought out plan and properly executed for both camps, everything that they've achieved.
Facts.
I would have been breeding. I would have been trying to create females for them dogs. I would have been doing breedings left and right.
That's what I'd be trying to
do. Left and right, bro. And I would have been keeping females out of that. I would have at least kept 4 females out of 4 completely different semi-related breedings.
Out of all the males I could have had right now, I fucking kept 2 females, 2 bitches. Out of all the males that I could have kept, out of all the breeds, I got 2 bitches right now. That's my 5. Matter of fact, I got 3. I got 4 bitches right now. I got one from Nick.
4 bitches.
That has a little masterpiece and all of that shit in there because that's what I need.
I always wanted to use that dog.
Nick, does Shinzy got masterpiece in her?
No.
No? Oh, man, I'm sad now.
We're talking about
Magoo,
right?
Magoo.
The American Bully. Master
Magoo and World Star. So she goes right to my program, what I'm doing, on a top end.
What are you talking about?
What's that?
A farm bitch that I got from
him. I took my bitch that I bred off of Doom, my champion female wolf. I bred her to Cornball, Randy's Grand Champ male. The fawn cornball. The kid Dougie has him out in Ohio.
Very shoulder in the front, very heavy in the front like this, cornball.
Fucking beast, yeah. He's a huge rear. Huge rear.
Yeah, he's grown. He's filled out now.
Yeah, he looks really
good. Has he filled out or is he fat?
No.
Nah. Not fat. His rear exploded.
He's on point, bro. He's on point.
I'm not talking crap. I'm just asking, bro.
No, we telling you.
So it's Randy.
But you'd have to assess the dog yourself. You know, you know what you're looking at. So
it's Randy's inbred world style female.
I'll try to get a picture.
Bred to cornbread, which is a Magoo son. And I took him and put him to my female off of Doom and my Waffle House female. And that's how I created them. And the boys that I had off that litter, the headpieces, bro. I'll send you a picture of them. Motherfucker got a king tail. He ain't ever going to be in the show ring, but.
Duh. Bro. I already know okay what I'm outcrossing to because.
Okay to keep.
Because
oh, hell yeah. I said, I ain't getting rid of him, dude.
I know what.
His brother, but he's the more boned up. He's got more body, more bone. His head is just ridiculous. I'll send you a picture in a little bit.
Yo, you want to know what's sad? That only one person did the video thing.
No, there was somebody else that did it. Hold on.
It was somebody. Like, I'll let other people do it. I figured you guys would be getting bombarded all day with.
Oh, they didn't do. They didn't do. Nah, it's going to take time. We popped up on them today with it. You know what I'm saying?
But, yo, you got to tell them, hey, we need some. Even if it doesn't have to be in ring, I'd prefer
you
to have.
You guys can take your dog out back and just take a video of
hey, walk.
Hold on, I got
go live with the dog. Put the camera down. Walk the dog away. Like have him on this with y'all, because I would prefer that there ain't no judge in the way and shit. You know what I mean? A couple back and forths, a little up and down, some stopping, and then submit a couple pictures that you can evaluate, zoom in on and shit. That's what I would
prefer. Yeah, I thought about doing it, but I didn't have any video.
Yeah, just go outside and record it.
Ain't nobody trying to do that. I sit on his couch, three drinks in.
Nobody wants to have Julio rip their dog apart, is what it was.
Is that what it was? Hell, I ain't bashful. I'm always open to
listen. Man, listen, there's certain people that I really do trust their opinion.
You're one of them.
And I will sit there and I will be like, yo, break the dog down, bro. I'm talking about hurt my feelings, bro. This is the best that I got. Break the dog down. Hurt my feelings. Let's go.
Well, in my opinion, any good breeder is willing to have somebody else look at their dog critically and point out things that they may see.
That's the point of getting in the ring.
And I'm never offended if somebody does that to my dog.
Mm-mm. That's the whole point of getting in the ring, man.
Absolutely.
What was it? North Carolina? What did I go to last?
You were at Allentown.
He said, Bernard said, culling has to be discussed more in order to improve everything. Ain't worth keeping or breeding. Yeah, soft cull, yep. Man. I would, yeah, soft cull.
Correct. Yeah. Pets.
We've talked about that on here before.
Yeah, that's another really big issue, too, is the fact that people will sell dogs that shouldn't be bred to people who are going to breed them fucking dogs. And that's why you have people, they were in the comment section earlier saying, like, oh, I get stuck with puppies. Yeah, because you're contributing to that overflow in the market.
But everybody gets stuck with puppies.
Oh, of course, but
everybody gets stuck with puppies.
If you're a breeder and you're putting these dogs in homes where they shouldn't be bred, and your dogs shouldn't be bred, they should be going to pet homes with contracts of
I'm gonna make it clear next week,
because now if they ain't pumping out puppies and adding to this market where we should be controlling this shit.
Yo, bro, so for example, like, I've had conversations with people that I've sat there and I'd be like, yeah, bro, all you got to do is a simple AI. What's an AI?
Oh, yeah.
Now, mind you, this person.
You can't just say AI right now. Motherfucker's going to be like, hold up. I just got to go online.
Yeah.
ChatGPT?
ChatGPT?
ChatGPT.
You got to be careful now, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but and these people already have litters.
How'd you get
bro,
that?
Bro, like,
man, listen, my homeboy that I fuck with, man, he probably on right now.
What's the matter, Max?
A lot of stuff that he knows now, I kind of put him on to it, or he just, if I didn't put him on to it, I probably reiterated the importance of it. You know what I'm saying? Through being told to him probably the 1,000th time or some shit like that, and it probably was like, you know what, yeah, alright, maybe I need to start doing this shit.
It's important to have people that are gonna fucking give you the right info, man. It really is.
Yeah, we need. I'm gonna make it more clear about the pictures and videos we need.
it's not just about the right info. It's also about some people. There's people that don't want to hear it, bro.
Yeah, true that.
Like I had a gentleman. I had a gentleman. What show did Coop have before Allentown, North Carolina, right?
Yeah,
right.
I think so. Yeah.
At that show, I met a young kid who tried to cut in line, and I didn't let him cut in line. Bro, he came on my neck, bro.
Uh-oh.
He came on my
line.
Neck, like,
in what line?
The food line.
Food line?
Oh, shit. I thought you meant that.
I was hungry. He wasn't going to get in front of me. But anyway, he came on my neck. He was like, hey, you guys need better dogs here in the ABKC. I was like, wait, what? You guys need better dogs here. So anyway, long story short, his dogs are a different registry, and he didn't know that all you need to do is take that paperwork and register ABKC for you to be able to show ABKC. Yeah. Isn't that sad?
That's less than info. What's he even doing there if he doesn't know that?
but it's not. I mean, it is what it is, bro. It's just lack of information. That's all it is.
Yeah.
It's lack of. He came on my neck and he left it educated.
Well, right.
Did he register his dog's ABKC?
Well, I don't know. The conversation was over with, you know what I mean? I would hope to run into him again and you know what I mean, and compete against him.
Yeah.
Because he was talking heavy. He said, you gotta need better dogs. Like, he has some fire, so I want to compete against him. I beat me.
What breed did he have?
I think bullies.
Yeah.
Young man.
I've been there before.
Hardcore stuff. Frenchie didn't be. Yeah, he's right. He's right. He's right. These breeds didn't become established by being soft.
Yeah. No, he ain't. He's talking about culling.
Yeah, I know.
Hard or soft cull. I don't think taking.
Explain to them what the difference is, bro.
I don't know, man. I just can't. I can't kill something that's alive. You know what I'm saying? Like that. I can fix it. I'll get it fixed, but I can't do that. I don't have the heart to do that shit. I done did some shit in my life. That shit might bring up some past fucking trauma, bro. I ain't doing no shit like that. Now, I seen dead puppies and fucking, you know what I'm saying, on some other
you
shit.
Have so. Some nightmares. I don't know. There have to be some real defects going on there for me to be like,
It would have to be some shit like, you know, a cleft palate or some shit like that.
Even at that, I would go to the vet. You know what I mean?
I would go to the vet. Now, I don't think I would want it to live, man.
Because
they give you a choice. They give you a choice at the vet, too.
Hey, girl.
Well, yeah, the cleft palates and the encephalitis,
hi.
You know,
how
that's a hard code.
I just sent him to let the dogs in. It's pouring outside.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good to see you.
Same to you.
You came, dog. You still glammed up. Look, it's almost midnight.
I'm in the robe, in the mall.
It's all good. Your skin all glowing and everything.
Thank you.
We see you. Diamond all shining all the way in the back.
Never take it off.
That ain't from no puppy money.
Nope. Yeah, man. But I think we just need to do we do need to fix these dogs that we don't have in our the plans for our program. But we do have three or four dogs that we see that I've seen Nick have six dogs that can actually fucking win titles. Oh, and that's done production, that's bred and had nice ass dogs that complemented the breed. So I don't know. I'm in a different time frame in my breeding program to where we have it, where I can say I have it to where I can see where it's gonna go right now. You know what I'm saying? I can kind of calculate it, you know.
Yeah, you have the experience.
And people around us are doing
a lot through trial. But through trial though.
Yeah, and paying attention to what other people are doing around you that have the same blood as you too.
That is key though. That is key. I paid attention to a lot of things that other people were doing and learned from it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, like I'll sell some of my puppies with a breeding back to Marshall and shit. Like I didn't do it with Ryan, but he came back to me. He has one of my doom daughters. We did that breeding. He had fucking like 13 puppies. But my God, man, some of these males are just ridiculous. I'm like, holy shit. All right. And I have this sitting in my yard. Like if I wanted to do that, I could do it. Huh?
I was going to do my breeding recently, bully breeding, but I stopped myself because I got too many dogs, bro.
If it was like Wooten said, there wouldn't be the Waffle House and the Charisma breeding. Them, well, it would have been that breeding, but it wouldn't have been them dogs off of that breeding.
Yeah. But you know what it is?
If they were just doing it for themselves, it would have just been tiny. That's it. It just would have been tiny.
Yeah.
All other dogs would have been fixed or hard culled. You know what I'm saying? Or soft culled. You know what I'm saying?
There's plenty of dogs out there that were supposed to be pet home. Fucking flu game.
Yeah, the pet home isn't really pet home these days, bro. You gotta, man, listen. Oof.
Yeah, look at flu game now, though.
I know. But that's what they were telling them. When they sold him the dog, they told him. They were like, oh, he's not a show dog. He did pretty goddamn well in the show ring.
Oh, did he?
Hell yeah. He's a grand.
He made two cuts with me at Nationals. Me, Marshall, him. I don't remember who else. I think there were three.
I like that Waffle House son, Kong.
What do you guys?
Yeah, he's nice.
I haven't seen him. I don't know what
you're talking about. I'm a gorilla.
What do you guys think about people that are able to champ the dog out based on numbers of show attended instead of?
Nah, that's why.
What, just
I think it should be marked on how many shows it took for that dog to reach a champion and a grand. I think it should be recorded.
Yeah, but the level of competition isn't the same at every show.
True.
It ain't. You're right.
So you can't really count that.
I got most of my majors at Julio's show. With the female I just champed out. I'm grateful for them ribbons, boy. Let me tell you.
Them things are dope, right?
Ass ribbons, my guy.
Them things are dope, right?
Yeah, so nice, bro.
That's all her. That's all her, bro. She has pallets. She has pallets. Putting them together, bro. She does it, yeah. Bro. I don't. I will never take credit for that.
Well, it's your show, but I gotta say I'm grateful for having them ribbons because you know, staring at blue ribbons and then pink ribbons just kind of, you know, just kind of gets old after.
Yeah, when you coming back out to VA, when you doing another show in VA?
Man, I still got issues with that damn venue, bro. They send me more money I owe them like 2 years later.
For what?
I don't even want to talk about it, bro.
Oh, Lord.
Bro, they sent me a bill. I'm like, wait, what? 2 years later? I'm like, what?
From a different venue? Why don't you use a different venue?
From the same show.
You could do it in Joel's yard.
Bro, I'm no like, yeah, you guys are bugging, but I'm gonna figure it out with them. I'm already talking to them. I would like to use that venue again. That was a dope venue.
You know what venue I want to go to again.
We're definitely gonna have PPNL, bro, but the community has to sign waivers or something. Everybody attending has to sign a waiver, bro.
Send me a message, fam. Send me a message.
Sign a waiver for what?
Because that damn parking lot, that loading dock, bro, was a disaster.
Trim it. I got you, man. I think I got your message. I'm on live, so give me a chance. Plus, my wife just got out of town, too, man, from Rhode Island. She just came from Rhode Island. Huh?
What did they do all in that parking lot?
Bro, let the dogs shit and then they pick it up.
Really?
Bro, I had to come back the next day and clean the whole lot.
That's what he got. That's what he got a damn bill for.
Garage, right? Yeah. I don't know. I remember we had to pull in and I don't know.
That's what your bill was, the deposit. They probably was like, nah, we gave him the deposit too quick.
This is, we're talking about the BPNL Center.
Yeah.
Oh.
In Allentown.
Yeah, that
that venue was dope.
There was I ain't been there. To go to the bathroom right inside. We had all that matting out and everything. It was like friggin' perfect. You could hose everything right off over there.
Nah, that venue was dope, bro. That venue was.
I love that place.
That venue was dope, but.
I felt like I got drafted to go in there and handle. Like, yo, shit, what was my first pick? First round.
Stupid.
I swear to God, bro. I'm telling you. When you walked into that place, I was like, what the fuck? I'm like, this is the Mecca.
And the keto and the keto thing at the top was dope.
Yeah. They did that for us. I had the hair standing up on my arm as soon as I walked in.
Hooked that up.
I wouldn't even do it three times, Brian. I wouldn't even do that shit three times. Shit, Shamrock, fuck that. I wouldn't even go back on that shit twice, man.
Who's Shamrock? That Dry Dog? Super Log?
The super high rare with the fucking short upper arm. He thick, but he got super short upper arm. He got fucking, he got an over-exaggerated chest. He is an extreme fucking dog, man. He's
a two.
Yo, I remember... I
didn't like him listen. That he fell apart young.
Hey, Nick. For him, you know? Do you remember when we went to the Allentown show and I seen him out there? He was showing everybody. I said, "Oh hell yeah!" I said, "Fuck yeah!" Right? Because there, no. Because there wasn't usually no big derail deal competition in the Grand Champion class. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, ooh, fuck yeah, let's go. Let's go. We got one of the top dogs in the ABKC at this bitch. You know what I'm saying? I go in a grand champion. I go in a grand champion.
Pumped up and just well promoted, I guess.
I go in a grand champion. I go in a grand champion fucking class.
Wasn't he? Well, didn't he not go in? Yeah, he didn't go in. I don't know if he was a grand yet, though, because
he was a grand, bro. There was
Marshall and Larry looked on him in friggin' Jersey.
Dog, he was a grand. And I think in that New Jersey show, we tapped on him in that New Jersey show when I had shots when he was 9 months, when he was going to get up against the bear.
I don't know if he was there. I remember.
No, he was there, bro. He was there.
Was he?
I remember. And I faced him against the champion class. And dusted him.
We dusted him hard.
Yo, you guys remember that dog, Ozell?
Who?
Ozell? Damn, nope. You guys missed out on that dog.
I came in when Eric had them dogs. What's them dogs? I came in when Ashton Martin and shit was.
Yeah, winning nationals, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just won nationals the year that.
That was the year after Eric, I came. Right? Huh?
That's Eric, right?
Yeah. Like that's people that's lost. That's lost art right there, man. That's lost. That's like archive shit. Him and his wife, him and his the girl. You know how many times she spanked me in the show ring? And she used to brag, but this is when my first few times, this was my first maybe two times in the show ring. But then Siren, then I start fucking learning, and I got Siren on a roll, and we went up against, and
try, right?
Yeah, dog.
Stifle. I'm like, what the fuck's a stifle?
I know, right? So we went up against Ashton Martin, brother. Hey. And we busted his ass for best of winners. She was pissed. I was so fucking happy. I was like, you take it there, you stupid bitch. So fucking uppity.
I got a lock.
I came from the UKC. So what, bitch? Go back to the UKC.
Yo, I'm gonna hit you up.
I hated that. I not hated. I really disliked her, man, because fam.
Later.
She really turned.
See you, Nick. Later.
She really turned. I know you ain't gonna talk about it, Julio, but she really turned her nose up at people, man. in the show ring. She wasn't a good, she was a good, she had a not a lot of knowledge, but she wasn't a good mentor.
She was a what?
She had a lot of knowledge, but she didn't have no wisdom to go behind it, or she just wasn't a patient person. It just was a, she was a piece of shit. Just everything about her, man. I'm not talking about her other shit. I'm just talking about her as a person in the show ring, just being fake. You know what I'm saying? Somebody like, I look up to the people who are like you, who are more like Nick, you know, that will help somebody that they don't even, know. What the fuck is going on, man?
Hey, Julio, while there's just a second, I'm gonna jump off here. There was a podcast that me and Joel did a while back that we spent 2 hours talking about nothing but the application of coefficient of inbreeding.
Send me that, Joel.
If you're interested, just check that out. I go over a whole bunch of stuff. I'm always and some of it you may want to use and some of it you may not want to, but it'll answer a lot of questions, maybe.
What do you think about hip testing?
What I think about it?
How important do you think it is?
I think that's another element of testing that we definitely need to do once the dog's old enough.
Ah, old enough.
Yeah. So like I embark test all my dogs, and then when they're 2 years old, then we take a look at the hips and the elbows. So hips, elbows, and cardiac, you know, are at least kind of like the three basics aside from the genetic testing.
You're referring to OFA.
I'm sorry.
You're referring to OFA.
Well, you could do OFA or pin hip, either one. I guess supposedly pin hip is
15 weeks
better. You know,
it's at a younger age.
Pin hip is.
Yeah, it's at a much younger age. You don't have to wait.
You know, the only thing is like
earlier, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've read some studies about hip stuff, and here's the thing with hip stuff. You know, a lot of times we blame it on on the genetics, but so much of hip dysplasia is environmental because people let their puppies jump off of stuff.
I agree.
You know? Mm-hmm. I'm trying to remember what the studies were saying, but it was something like they could attribute 70-80% of hip dysplasia issues to environmental issues and not genetic.
Okay. Well, thank you for your time, bro. I appreciate you.
No, I was happy to be on, Joel. Thank you, man. I
appreciate it. I just sent it to him too.
Yeah,
glad to see you back on.
Yeah, man, we're gonna try to do this every Monday, at least with me and Julio and this open panel. But we're gonna definitely tap into because I love this, man. I love doing this. I love talking like this, man. This is only gonna make us better as people and warriors in this game, because iron only sharpens iron. You know what I'm saying?
And the only way the community gets better is just to talk about it, you know.
Facts. So jeez, we're gonna,
bro, you got 230 comments on your podcast. That's dope.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so yeah, man. Hey, man, I'd like to thank all of the guests that came on. I'd like to thank Lance Lee, definitely our next guest that'll be on here. I'd like to thank,
when is that, Sunday, you said?
Sunday at 9 o'clock. I'd like to thank Jerry James. I definitely like to give a shout out to Nick Angry Ink for jumping on. And last but not least, man, my guy Julio. Like I said earlier, I didn't want to jack up your last name, man.
Quevedo. There you go. You got it, man.
So, hey, you know, I'm Venezuelan too. You know what I'm saying? I got a little bit of that in me. But I'd like to thank all of our guests that came on, man. I know you're a busy man. You know, you got your daughter and your crawling all over you. You know what I'm saying? You got your wife in the background. She ready for you to get, take your ass to bed. You know what I'm saying? So I'd like to really thank you for coming on. Do you want to give your feed for social media, Instagram, your TikTok, your Facebook?
Right there, man. Ink and Bullies, right in the blue. Everywhere you go, that's all you got to type.
And closing statements for everybody?
Get yourself a mentor.
That's facts.
Get yourself a mentor, man. Listen, if they ain't willing to invest the time with you, then don't invest your money with them. That'll be my best advice for everybody, man.
Hey, and this is one of the realest ones that we got in the books right now. So
thank you.
Hey, man. You stay blessed, fam. I love you, man. And you be easy. Yes, sir.
Stay blessed, brother. Peace.
Yep. Man, we like to thank our guests for jumping on. And this is what it's about, man. This is what it's about. It's about us learning from each other because we learn from the chat. You know, I'm not all big and bad. Well, I'm above all. One thing I'm not above is the truth. That's one thing I'm not above. It's facts. That's one thing I'll never be above. And you know, sometimes my wife hits me with facts and I have to fucking suck it up. You know, I used to fight it. You know, now you got to suck it up. You know, I hit her with facts, you know, she got to suck it up. So all of us have to do it, man. We adults, man. We have to learn when the truth is being told to us out of, even if it's being told to us out of in venom. It's the truth. It's just raw and uncut. You know what I'm saying? Let me see what I got over here. You know, I like to play myself out. So, y'all be easy, man. I love y'all and play myself out. You already know.
No joke, I used to let the mic smoke. Now I slam it when I'm done and make sure it's broke. When I'm gone, no one gets on, cause I won't let nobody press up and mess up the scene I set. I like to stand in a crowd and watch the people wonder, damn. But think about it, then you understand. I'm just an addict, addicted to music. Maybe it's a habit, I gotta use it. Even if it's jazz or the quiet storm, I hook a beat up, convert it into hip-hop form. Write a rhyme and graffiti in every show you see me in. Deep concentration, cause I'm no comedian. Jokers are wild, if you wanna be tame. I treat you like a child and you're gonna be named another enemy, not even a friend of me. Cause you'll get fried in the end when you pretend to be competing. Cause I just put your mind on pause and I complete when you compare my rhyme with yours. I wake you up and as I stare in your face, you seem stunned. Remember me, the one you got your idea from. But soon you start to suffer, the tune'll get rougher. When you start to stutter, that's when you had enough of fighting, it'll make you choke. You can't provoke, you can't cope. You should have broke because I ain't no joke. Joke. As serious as cancer, who can keep the average dancer hyper as a heart attack? Nobody's smiling, cause you're expressing the rhyme that I'm styling. This is what we all sit down to write. You can't make it, so you take it home, break it and bite. Use pieces and bits of all my hip-hop hits. Get the style down, packed in, it's time to switch. Put my tape on pause and add some more to yours. Then you figured you're ready for the neighborhood chores. The E-M-C-E-E, don't even try to be. When you come up to speak, don't even lie to me. You like to exaggerate, dream and imagine it. Then change the rhyme around, that could aggravate me. So when you see me come up, freeze, or you'll be one of those seven MCs. They think that I'm a new jack, but only if they knew that. They who think wrong, or they who can't do that style that I'm doing, they might ruin patterns of paragraphs based on you. And you're all be DJ, if anything he play sound familiar, I'll wait till E-Safe play him. So I'ma have to diss who broke, you can get a smack for this. I ain't no joke. The microphone like a grudge. a whole record so the needle don't budge. I hold a conversation cause what I invent, I nominated my DJ the president. When I'm CI, I'll keep a freestyle going steadily, so pucker up and whistle my melody. But whatever you do, don't miss one, there'll be another rough rhyme after this one. Before you know it, you're following it, fiending, waiting for the punchline to get the meaning. Like before, the moral of my story I'm telling, nobody beats the art, so stop yelling, save it, put it in your pocket for later, cause I'm moving the crowd and be a record fader. No interruptions till the mic is broke. When I'm gone, then you can joke, cause everything is real on a serious tip. Keep playing and I get furious quick, and I take it for a walk through hell. Freeze your dome, then watch your eyeballs swell. Guide you out of triple stage darkness. When it get dark again, then I'ma spark this microphone, cause the heat is on. You see smoke in the finish when the beat is gone. I'm no joke, no joke, no joke.